talking about. This is what the game will look like on ESPN2 with the action there and the ISO cameras all the way around. What about the ESPNU cameras above the rim? That's what the game will look like as you see the traditional coverage there and what it looks like from above on ESPNU. Any way you want to see this game, we are providing it for you tonight. We've talked about Kia Vaughn. We've talked about Candace Parker and the coaches. But who are the players that maybe a lot of people out there don't know tonight, guys, that could become the X factor for either Rutgers or Tennessee?
Well, the X factor for Tennessee for me is Alexis Hornbuckle. I've said all along, she is the difference between them being a Final Four team and a national championship team. When you look at the matchup with Rutgers, she's the only perimeter player to me that matches up size and athleticism and the ability to defend them.
Well, Kara, our Doris Burke talks about the Renaissance woman in Essence Carson. She's a 6-foot junior. I look at her to guard the likes of 20 and 10. 20 and 10 is Candace Parker. She's the best player in the country. That could be a terrific athletic matchup in this game.
It's the best thing about this game is that you can say ahead of time, this person's going to be the star, that person's going to be the star, but you never know until it plays out who is going to sneak up and surprise you, and we'll see if it's one of those players that Kara and Stacy just mentioned. When we return on the Championship Special, we will put these two to the test. They will tell you, will it be Rutgers or will it be Rocky Top at the top again, and they will tell you why when we return on the Championship Special.
First, there were the pajamas your uncle got you when you were born. After that, it was your first glove. Your first real glove. Next, it was sitting in the kitchen asking your dad about the designated hitter. But then you saw what is to this day the bluest sky and the greenest grass you could ever see. And that's when it really started.
If you're a man over 50, it's time to take the Avidart quiz. Are you always going? Do you have trouble going? Are you going at night? Maybe you think you have a going problem. But what if it's a growing problem? What if it's not your bladder, but instead you have an enlarging prostate? 50% of men over 50 do, and you may be able to do something about that going and growing with Avidart. Most medicines only treat symptoms. Avidart, with time, actually shrinks the prostate and improves urinary symptoms. Only your doctor can tell if your symptoms are from an enlarged prostate and not a more serious condition, such as prostate cancer. So have regular prostate exams. Avidart is for men only. Women should not take or handle Avidart due to the risk of a specific birth defect. Tell your doctor if you have liver disease. Rarely, sexual side effects, tenderness, or swelling of the breast can occur. Have you called your doctor? Avidart, for your growing problem.
Tip time coming up in just a little bit. Rutgers, Tennessee, one game to decide it all. All right, Kara Stacy, put them up, shut them up. Who's winning and why?
I like Tennessee on the strength of Candace Parker and her presence opening it up for the other players.
I got to go with Rutgers. I think they got the best defense. They're peaking offensively, and they've got that mystique, and it's called youth and inexperience.
Sometimes you just don't know any better, and you have to wonder if that's what's going to play out for the second straight year in the national championship. Enjoy the game. It will be great. Here's Mike Patrick.
Trey, thanks very much. Here in the city where rock and roll was coined, only two remain. One from Springsteen's Jersey, tough, gritty, and born to run. The other, Tennessee, where there's a steady backbeat of country music and basketball titles. 40 minutes, two teams, and the drive to glory. Only one ticket to ride.
In a place where legends reside, another star is about to be enshrined. 64 distinct tunes distilled to a pair of intertwined melodies. Legendary leaders, one who last stepped on the ultimate stage a quarter century ago.
I really would like to know what it feels like to win the national championship.
Another who has tasted more victory than anyone else, but never lost the hunger for more.
I don't stop and think about winning a seventh national championship, I think about this team winning their first.
An elite roster piloted by the country's best player who combines skill and aggression.
That's what my team needs me to do. You just gotta raise your level of play in pressure situations. That's what determines, you know, winners from losers.
A young band marked by fire and ferocity who summon finesse when it's needed.
Don't underestimate the power and the faith that we have within each other.
They can't miss a thing. Holy cow, blows by. Got it.
That is just great defense.
Tennessee on a 10-0 run.
This is the stage where legends are made. Rutgers, Tennessee, the championship game.
Welcome to the NCAA Women's Championship, presented on ESPN by Orbitz. From Cleveland, Ohio, it's the Rutgers Scarlet Knights at 27-8 against the 33-3 Lady Vols of Tennessee. This championship usually belongs to a team that has won it before. Tennessee has 6 titles. Rutgers has never won. This championship usually belongs to a highly ranked team. Tennessee is number 2, Rutgers number 18. No team outside of the top 10 has ever won. This championship usually belongs to a number 1 seed. Tennessee is a number 1. Rutgers is a number 4. No team seeded 4th or lower has ever won. Good evening, everybody. Mike Patrick, Doris Burke, great to have you with us. With all that historical background, this is a total mismatch, right?
Not when a team has captured that something special that only March has to offer. Rutgers has one of the nation's best defenses, and when they make shots, Mike, they are tough to beat. That gritty, that athletic, that tough-minded defense specializes in taking away an opponent's best option to score. That was Duke's Lindsey Harding from the point, Arizona State's Emily Westerberg from the power forward, and the nation's best center, Sylvia Fowles. She had been dominant. She was rendered ineffective, each underperformed. Can they do it again tonight against Candace Parker?
Of course, this is the biggest stage there is for women's basketball, and Candace Parker, arguably the best player in this game.
Yeah, I don't think there's any question, and Tennessee tonight will look to move her around the floor to try to take advantage of a wealth of skills. This is the most complete player in college basketball with the most refined skill set that you can offer. She is most dangerous around the rim at 6'4", an intimidating athletic defensive performer, but a person who can go off the dribble, can make shots with her back to the basket or facing up. This is not somebody you can guard with one. I look for Rutgers to send a lot of different looks at her.
All right, how about your star watch, Doris?
Yeah, Matea Ajabon is a skilled athlete who's an explosive scorer out of the one, and Parker's legacy is on the deck tonight. Will she step up and become a legend?
We're looking forward to a great ball game. So we're 20,704 here in Cleveland. We'll be back with the starting lineups right after this.
The NCAA Women's Championship is presented on ESPN by Orbitz. Save big at Orbitz.com. Just Orbitz and go. And in part by Volvo. Experience the full line of 2007 Volvos. Who would you give a Volvo to? Volvo for life. And refreshingly smooth Bud Light. Always worth it.
So due to weather, our next departure is 6 a.m. tomorrow.
Lady.
It's time to play Take on Orbitz. Today's players have bad weather, must book a hotel before the other 200 passengers. Go.
Oakwood?
Yes.
Dentmore?
Oh, no vacancy. Orbitz TLC lets you find a hotel right from your phone. Next time, Orbitz and go.
Think we'll make it?
I don't wanna get left behind. Gonna love my baby all the time.
It has everything you expect of a European luxury import. And protects the luxury of life, like you own.
Welcome back to Cleveland. A sellout crowd of 20,000 waiting to see a national championship between Rutgers and Tennessee. Two of the winningest coaches in the history of basketball. Pat Summitt, number one. C. Vivian Stringer, number three on the wins list. Pat Summitt, of course, with six championships to her credit. C. Vivian Stringer looking for her first. This will be the 15th title game between them. Let's go to the public address announcer, Agnes Green.
On behalf of the NCAA, welcome to the Division I Women's Basketball National Championship game. Please stand as our nation's colors are presented this evening by the 3rd U.S. Infantry, traditionally known as the Old Guard. And now to honor America and those who support our freedom at home and abroad, please join Cleveland's own Ann Cochran in the singing of our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land
turnaround for Rutgers this year as they have advanced to a national championship game after a miserable start. Just 2-4 at the beginning of the year with this young team. The biggest turnaround, points allowed and field goal defense. They have become arguably the best defensive team in the country after being horrible at the beginning of the season. Tennessee, of course, used to being here. 97-19 in the NCAA tournament all time. They have been to every Sweet 16, 17 Final Fours, and they have won a record NCAA championships, a half dozen. Let's go back to Agnes Green for the starting lineups.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Quicken Loans Arena for tonight's national championship game between the University of Tennessee Lady Volunteers and the Rutgers University Scarlet Knights. Now let's meet the starting lineup. At forward for Rutgers, a 6-foot junior from Paterson, New Jersey, number 5, Essence Carson. At forward for Tennessee, a 6'4 sophomore from Naperville, Illinois, number 3, Candace Parker. At forward for Rutgers, a 6'1 sophomore from Montvale, New Jersey, number 21, Heather Zurich. At forward for Tennessee, a 6'3 senior from Hoover, Alabama, number 1, Sydney Spencer. At center for Rutgers, a 6'4 sophomore from the Bronx, New York, number 15, Kia Vaughn. At center for Tennessee, a 6'4 junior from Staten Island, New York, number 55, Nikki Anasicki. at guard for Rutgers, a 5'9 freshman from Brooklyn, New York, number 10, Epiphany Prince. At guard for Tennessee, a 5'11 junior from Charleston, West Virginia, number 14, Alexis Hornbuckle. At guard for Rutgers, a 5'8 junior from Newark, New Jersey, number 22, Marti Ajavan. At guard for Tennessee, a 5'2 junior from New York, New York, number 00, Shannon Bobbitt. And introducing the head coaches for Rutgers in her 12th season, C. Vivian Stringer. And for Tennessee in her 33rd season, Pat Summit.
Mark Jones and Holly Rowe will work the sidelines for us tonight. Let's check in with Holly.
Well, Pat Summit celebrates her 20th national championship this year. And what she has said is that she has changed a lot in those years since the first one as a coach. She said she's much more attuned with what the players need and feel instead of just what she's thinking. She said, I rely a lot on this team for feedback. That was the case, a late game situation against North Carolina in the semifinal. The players wanted a different defense. She changed what they wanted. They came out and got a turnover. But her legendary focus is the same. She has secluded her players. She took away their cell phones last night, and she said she doesn't even know where her cell phone is. She said, Holly, it's been since 1998 that I've cut down anything. I'm not looking for a phone. I'm looking for some scissors. Now let's check in with Mark Jones.
Holly, C. Vivian Stringer has taken three different teams to the Final Four, but this year's addition of Rutgers are the quintessential survivors, and they take their cue from their head coach, Stringer. They've watched as Stringer has survived the loss of her husband suddenly back in 1992 because of a heart attack. They've gained strength from watching Stringer raise their daughter, Nina, who has spinal meningitis. In fact, Kia Vaughn, their starting center, told me that, Mark, she motivates us every day. She has us believing that we can jump over a building if we have to. Back to you, Mike.
Thanks, Mark. Tonight's women's championship game is a full circle event on the ESPN family of networks right here on ESPN. The traditional game coverage, ESPN2, features a six box with close-ups of the legendary coaches, C. Vivian Stringer and Pat Summit, and two boxes for star players, as well as a box for replay and stats. In addition, ESPNU will have constant above-the-rim coverage and get enhanced coverage on ESPN 360 and ESPN.com. And we are set to go for a national title. Tennessee controls the opening tip. 5-2, Shannon Bobbitt gives it up to Sydney Spencer, who had a tough shooting game the other night. Anna Sickey backing in on Vaughn. Doesn't get the roll, but it tipped out. Nice job by Hornbuckle to keep it alive for Tennessee.
Rutgers opens man-to-man, exactly what Stacey Dales talked about in the pregame show. Essence Carson, the long athletic forward, will check Candace Parker.
Bobbitt launches the three and nails it. She is better than 40% from long range.
Pat Summit talked about the fact that because Rutgers does such a good job of taking away your best scorer, people around Candace Parker will have to make shots. I got to believe Bobbitt hitting that one makes Pat take a sigh of relief over there.
Rutgers 8 out of 10 in the first half the other night. Can't start with a three. Parker stripped from behind. Got it to Hornbuckle anyhow. Bobbitt wide open. A tremendous ball handler. That one's kicked and will go out of bounds to Tennessee.
I like no reset on the shot clock. This was a rule they instituted last year. Active feet, Mike, means that you sometimes kick the basketball, and so you don't reward the offense with a new 30.
Spencer, turnaround jumper, got it. That's a great sign for Tennessee.
No question. You could not have asked for two better things to happen to start the ball game for the Lady Vols. Support for Candace Parker initially. That can help Candace relax and not feel the burden to carry this team to a championship.
And if Spencer gets hot, you better look out. For most of the year, she was the number one three-point shooter in the entire country. This is Prince, who had a great game in the semifinals, her best of the tournament. She gives it up to Adjabon, who has blossomed as a superstar here. And Spencer will pick up the foul, her first.
Tennessee foul.
C. Vivian Stringer said this was her least likely team to make the Final Four. They had to beat East Carolina, Michigan State, then the rematch with Duke. That was the big game. They had lost to the Blue Devils by 40 earlier in the season.
Early in November, she said this was the worst defensive team she'd ever coached. It's become the best.
Adjabon, who is cold-blooded, knocks this down, and they're going to check with each other if it was a two or a three. They can go to the monitor for this and see if there was a toe on the line.
Well, one of those officials, in fact, the one on the left is Lisa Mattingly. The one on the right is Tina Napier. Along with Michael Price, they make up the national championship crew. Congratulations to Lisa Mattingly. This is her seventh straight championship game. And is that toe on the line by Adjabon?
Watch, you can't see, can you?
Well,
they
called it a three.
I don't know if that's close enough to reverse. This is not like football where you have to have overwhelming visual evidence. There's nothing in the rule about that wording. But if her toe was on the line, it was a millimeter of it. Try to give you another look. I love this.
Well, just what the players need. They're not nervous enough. We're going to stop the game in the first 3 minutes and give them some more time to think about it. I'll tell you one of the keys for Tennessee, they talked an awful lot about individual defense and contesting shots early. Remember, Carol Lawson talked about the fact that she thought Tennessee would put some pressure on the shooters. Well, Hornbuckle a little bit slow as you see the replay.
Here's Tennessee's road to the championship. And really, they were not stressed by anybody until the North Carolina game here in the Final Four. Well, I tell you what, this, let's make a decision and get on with it. And they're going to call it a three. John Madry, our statistician, suggested they call it a two and a half and resume play, but there's no room on the scoreboard for the half.
Good switch by Kia Vaughn on the exchange by Essence Carson.
Hornbuckle, nice pull up, but she can't hit the shot. Prince with a rebound. She had 9 rebounds out of the backcourt the other night. That almost a travel, but they don't get the call, and Vaughn will shoot the jumper. And the Sickie with a rebound.
Well, Vaughn has got some size in there. It'll be interesting to see if Rutgers gets her isolated on the box. Can she do some damage?
Trying to get it into Parker and kicked again.
Kia Vaughn, 6'4", more than held her own against the nation's best post player at Sylvia Fowles. I thought she was a key part of that win.
Parker with a deep inbound. Carson waiting for it. Parker will shoot over and miss. Rebound to Tennessee.
That shot is the best case scenario. Rutgers would like to make Candace Parker a jump shooter or somebody who has to operate off the dribble.
And the sickie as they try to work high-low post with Parker inside. Spencer picked up her dribble. Bobbitt's a threat to launch it. She has no fear of anything. Spencer. Another offensive rebound. Tennessee just killing Rutgers on the boards right now. Parker likes to face up and then back in and drew the contact and the foul.
That is going to be where she can best take advantage of that matchup with Essence Carson.
Carson at 6 feet gives up 4 inches to Parker.
At the line for 2 shots, Candace Parker.
She won the Wade Trophy this week, which is the biggest prize in women's basketball, as a National Player of the Year. Everybody's first team All-American. This is the first free throw. Question remains, will she make herself eligible for the draft? She has until tomorrow at 10 a.m. to declare she would have to graduate by December in order for that to happen.
Correct, and Nancy Lieberman reporting later on some circumstances that may have an influence on that decision. We'll see how that goes.
Job by Carson to get through all that pressure. Syracuse open, passed on the three.
If Rutgers does not score in transition, then they slow the pace and look to attack inside of 10. You've got to be tight here.
And that's going to be a foul. It's on Anasicki, her first.
Tennessee foul on Nikki Anasicki, her first team.
Anasicki played all 40 minutes against North Carolina the other night and had a big game. 14 points, 7 rebounds, 4 block shots, and 5 steals.
Yeah, I thought she was their MVP along with Shannon Bobbitt. When that team was struggling to make points, it was Nikki Anasicki who stepped up. Both players played with a great amount of toughness. Anasicki tonight, Mike, will guard on the perimeter. At her size, that is a unique situation.
Prince, like most of these kids, a real good free throw shooter. And Rutgers has gotten so much better from the line as the season progressed. But that's a first, and she misses the second. Spencer, she wanted that shot. Had a good look, couldn't hit it. Another offensive rebound.
You've got to be strong with the ball. Kia Vaughn had done everything except keep control of the basketball on the board.
Good ball movement, wide open as Bobbitt couldn't hit it. There's Carson down low getting the rebound. Zurich with a runner. One and done for Rutgers. Anasicki, the outlet to Hornbuckle. 4 rebounds already for Anasicki. And she'll try a 17-footer. Out to Tennessee.
The support players around the Wade Trophy winner, Candace Parker, are going to have to make shots because Rutgers will make it hard on her to score. The first shot of the game, Shannon Bobbitt from New York drains it, and then Sydney. Your steps up.
Presented by Olivia. 6-4, Tennessee with the early lead in the women's title game here in Cleveland. Tennessee basketball, as they have dominated the rebounding numbers early in this game.
Well, they've got 5 offensive boards. Rutgers has got to fix that.
10-2 with that one.
That's 6 offensive boards. Sometimes Tennessee's best shot is their second shot. You've got to be fundamentally sound and put a body on somebody.
Parker sets the screen for Hornbuckle. Anasicki backing in. And 3-second call. Go to Mark Jones. Mark?
Guys, you were referring to the second chance opportunities that Rutgers has given Tennessee right now. That's exactly what C. Vivian Stringer addressed in her last huddle. She said, hey, guys, you have to know about Anasicki. She's a great offensive rebounder. Meanwhile, at the offensive end, she wants them to play inside out, ending her huddle by saying, guys, the next 5 minutes is chapter 2. It's crucial. Back to you guys.
Double team on Carson. Finds a way to save it and just got it away to Carson after Adjamon had been doubled up. Shot clock at 6. Carson, nice cut down the lane. Basket and a good no call.
Absolutely outstanding no call. Hornbuckle was too deep in the paint to give her any kind of reward for that kind of defense. Exceptional off the bounce is Rutgers inside of 10 seconds. You better come with good individual defense for Tennessee.
And they are fearless. We're tied at 6. Rutgers in their zone. Anasicki kicks it out, and Spencer to fire. Another offensive rebound. Sometimes That's a problem with the zone.
Well, Mark Jones just said it. I mean, Nikki Anasicki has got 103 offensive boards. They addressed her in the huddle. Find her. In essence, Carson, Rutgers wants to control tempo, so if they don't score in transition, shot clock's going to get under 10, and this is what they'll do, folks. Use all that athleticism to rise and fire close range.
Epiphany Prince picked up the last foul. Bobbitt will reset it. Tennessee has missed its last 8 shots. Parker double team, great pass. And the Suki couldn't hit the shot. She thought she was fouled. And there's a travel violation.
Well, one of the things Rutgers is doing right now is they're gambling off of Nikki Anasicki, Mike. They are taking Kia Vaughn, and anytime Candace Parker's around the box, they're sending a different defender. They're coming with Kia Vaughn.
Brittany Ray is going to come in to give Anasicki a breather. She did not leave the ballgame against North Carolina. If you're joining us late, Rutgers and Tennessee for a national championship, 13-44. Good go first half of play. We're tied at 6. Even though Tennessee is just killing Rutgers on the board. Bobbitt trying to drive, gets cut off. Parker with a runner short. 0 for 3 from the floor for Parker. A good catch by Carson.
Well, outstanding defense by Carson, making Candace Parker work for it.
Bad pass by Adjavon. Bobbitt, the only one there to get it. Hornbuckle passed on the shot and then tried to drive, knocked away, and out to Rutgers.
One of the most dangerous things you can do against C. Vivian Stringer and this vaunted defense, and look at the numbers, all of those season lows that you see highlighted. One of the most dangerous things you can do against a Rutgers team that's so athletic and has some of the fastest hands in the country, put the ball in the deck. You are asking for it to be stripped.
Carson got it in the lane. Pull-up jumper and hits it. Rutgers takes the lead.
How's that for patience? Don't panic under duress of a triple or a double team, Mike. Just take your time. Be composed.
With all the second chances they've given Tennessee, how do they have the lead?
That's amazing that they have not boarded it and been able to sustain this.
Adjavon. Got it inside, but Kia Vaughn, she missed the shot in Zurich. Will commit a foul coming over the back, trying to get a rebound.
Rutgers foul number 21, Heather Zurich, her first personal, third team foul.
That is the third team foul against Rutgers. Tennessee has committed 2 here in the first half. Bobbitt, who was admittedly overwhelmed after transferring from junior college at the beginning of the season, isn't overwhelmed anymore. She'll play with anybody and with a lot of confidence.
And she infuses this team with energy and toughness, Shannon Bobbitt. I love what she's added.
Spencer, and that was a pushing foul as she got the shot and a nice cut.
Rutgers foul number 21.
It's going to be on Zurich, her second.
Fourth team foul.
Tennessee has not hit a bucket since 1837 was on the first half clock. That's 6 minutes and 37 seconds ago.
Yeah, this is the kind of thing Rutgers does. It's amazing when you look at the constitution of Rutgers. 5 freshmen, no seniors. They started out with Adjavon injured. She had to have a rod inserted into her leg in order to deal with a stress fracture. They get out of the gates 2-4, and they become one of the nation's best teams. An amazing transformation.
The only people that weren't surprised were the players. They thought they could do it.
And, Mike, we haven't seen them overwhelmed by any moment thus far. Not against Duke in the regional semifinals, and not since they've arrived here in Cleveland.
They have always played like they believed they were the better team, and they believed they were going to win. They blinked in the whole tournament. Tennessee has missed its last 11 as it travels on Essence Carson. Big game, obviously, for both coaches. Close friends. C. Vivian Stringer still looking for that elusive national championship. Pat Summitt looking for number 7.
Think we'll make it?
I don't want to get an empty.
is everything you expect of a European luxury import. And protects the luxury of life like you only expect from a Volvo. Introducing the all-new Volvo S80.
Lease a 2007 S80 3.2 base for $439 a month for 24 months.
We represent the Coke brand. We would like to sue Coca-Cola Zero.
Would you say that we have a case?
For what?
For taste infringement.
We want to just sue them back to the Stone Age to send a message that they're tampering with, really, the flagship of the company.
It's one company. It's like you suing yourself.
Yeah.
But they're on a different part of our floor.
Da, 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 da.
Glidden Team Colors Paint, you can get the official colors of your favorite team.
Sir, you all set.
Whoever that may be, exclusively from Glidden and only at the Home Depot.
Traffic ahead.
Incredible. You found a golf course near the conference. Awesome Chinese. Now you find me a way around traffic. I love you.
Turn around. Every now and then I get a little bit lonely.
Take Market Street exit.
You're right. We'll just keep it professional, you know?
Go everywhere, find everything. Fall hard for the new Wear 2 GPS at Avis.
The Empire State Building lit up in red in honor of the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers, going for their first national championship since they shared, get this, the men's fencing title in 1949 with Army.
Wow, well, it's amazing what the football team has done, and if this team can couple that success with a women's basketball championship, that is the kind of thing that can elevate an athletics department. It puts it into the forefront of recruits' minds, Mike, and that is what it's all about in any sport, getting players.
Absolutely. Whistle away from the ball. It'll be a hold on Vaughn.
Five team fouls on Bolt. So not long before we're in the bonus. A couple more on each.
Parker for the wide open shot. Nice inbound play. Got her a screen and she was open. Nobody switched.
Yeah, that's a timing play. In essence, Carson was having a hard time contending from 15 feet. As Parker got ahead of steam up.
Tennessee trying to ratchet up the defensive pressure. Pick up your dribble against Tennessee's defense. It's at your own jeopardy. Adjavon trying to drive. Lost the ball. The shot won't go for McCurdy, who's in for the first time. And here comes Bobbitt.
Well, that could have been an offensive foul on Parker, backing down Carson.
Really loves that fadeaway jumper. She has six in the first half. The lead back to four.
You can see where Tennessee wants to take advantage of her skills. At 6'4", with a smaller defender giving up 4 inches, clearly it is an impossible check on that turnaround jump shot. You can't get a hand in her face to defend that.
Adjavon got caught up in the air, somehow got the ball back, and got it to Vaughn inside. What a great job by Adjavon. Here comes Bobbitt. He's going to push the tempo. Parker calls out the play that she wants. Auguste is in for Tennessee, and she gets the pass from Parker. Tied up inside, 3 second violation. And the third turnover against Tennessee.
Candace Parker started 0-for-3. This is a little timing play off the inbounds pass. They get her isolated, an easy deuce. Then back to the basket. That fadeaway jump shot, she goes away from the double team.
12-10. Ball to Adjavon. This is the driving layup. Vaughn gets the rebound. Kia Vaughn unspectacularly does a lot of dirty work down court. Offensive rebound and a foul. That looked like a reach-in on Prince, and it is her second.
You'll see if Kia Vaughn has dropped 30-plus pounds off her frame as they go to the rack. Look at her pursue the basketball. Excellent hands, nice, strong frame. This is a star in the making right here.
Augusti out of Marrero, Louisiana. Only a 65% free throw shooter. Got the roll on that one. Let's go to Holly Rowe.
During that last timeout, Pat Summitt was fired up. She came fierily over to the bench, slammed her fist on her whiteboard, and drew four circles around the perimeter of her whiteboard and said, if this is what we continue to do, we will lose. We cannot win this game if we don't score points in the paint. You can see the last two possessions, they've made more of an emphasis to get it inside. In fact, Candace Parker told her team in that huddle, look, give me a look, guys. I'll work for y'all tonight.
All right, Holly, thanks very much. Parker getting a breather right now as we had a blocking foul called on Tennessee. That will be on Augusti, her first, trying to draw the charge.
Well, the reason they want to take advantage of points in the paint is they have more size. Essence Carson addressed it. She said, we're not going to grow overnight, folks. We're not going to gain a couple of inches.
Timeout by Rutgers as they were having trouble getting the ball inbounds. The NBA on ESPN continues with a doubleheader tomorrow night, 7:30 Eastern. The Bulls against the Pistons. Then at 10 o'clock, the Sacramento Kings take on the Denver Nuggets. NBA Wednesday on ESPN. Also available on ESPN HD. Bobbitt with 10 on the shot clock.
Well, where do your points come from now? Candace Parker, the offense usually runs through her.
Where does anything come from? Barely got off a shot, and that is a shot clock violation.
Can't imagine they need either Hornbuckle or Parker back in the game to generate some offense.
Well, they're both going to come back in.
Candace Parker.
But the players on the court have to realize not only who is there, but who isn't. Like, you've got to get a shot when you are uncontested from 20 feet.
Yeah, personnel is a fairly important thing to be aware of.
Tennessee's lead is only two, although they seem to have dominated twice in the first 11 and a half minutes. Carson. Double team as the shot clock works down to nine. Tennessee doing a better job defensively. Then Vaughn has it knocked away, and it's off of Vaughn.
What's happening out front is as soon as that shot clock goes under 10, Mike, Tennessee comes with a ball screen trap. You know Rutgers wants to drive off the 10, and so they come with a trap, and they make things tough.
Vaughn will go out, and Rashida Junaid, the freshman out of New Jersey, will come in. She's given them some valuable minutes. She's really good in the middle, tends to get in foul trouble quickly. Parker, double team, kicks it outside. Augusti wheels into the lane, banked it home. Nice shot.
Remember the report by Holly. Let's get point paints. And that's exactly the size differential I'm talking about. That's what Pat Summitt was referencing in that last timeout.
Prince, beautiful spin into the lane, great dish. Epiphany Prince shows you why she was such a great player in high school. She was known for her scoring then, but she's a terrific ball handler.
Yeah, she's very unselfish. I like the way she's approached her time at Rutgers. She has tried to blend in after being a star in high school.
Parker goes with a left hand and misses. Rutgers with a chance to tie with a two. A three would give them the lead. 7 minutes, 4 seconds, and counting. Adjavon. Pat Summitt calling out encouragement to her defense. A lot of contact, offensive foul. McCurdy out of control, goes down the lane, picks up her first. Back in a moment.
The 2007 Motor Trend Truck of the Year would be a tough act to follow. So we took the lead instead. Introducing the most powerful heavy duty on the planet, the all-new Silverado HD. This is our
country. First, there were the pajamas your uncle got you when you were born. After that, it was your first glove. Your first real glove. Next, it was sitting in the kitchen asking your dad about the designated hitter. But then you saw what is to this day the bluest sky and the greenest grass you could ever see. And that's when it really started.
For complete car care, it's CarX, where our lifetime brakes come with a free oil change. Lifetime brakes from $79.95, and that's $79.95 installed, plus a free CarX oil change.
Don't worry, call the CarX man.
When your child gets sick with the usual illnesses an unusual number of times, it could be an immune deficiency called PI. Get the warning signs.
So, 12 o'clock tea time, someone rear-ends us. Day's shot, right? Except I just switched to Progressive Direct Online. They gave me a couple of competitive prices. I pick Progressive and save $400 a year. And I've been trying to tell these guys I also get their concierge service. So I drop off my car, pick up a rental, and we're gone. So I save $400 and our tea time. Fantastic.
Progressive Direct. It's about you. And it's about time. Sign up online and save $50.
Welcome back to Cleveland, Tennessee, up by two. Candace Parker is 2 for 6 to start this basketball game. She is having to contend with a double team every time she catches the basketball. Now, Pat Summitt told us yesterday she does not want Candace Parker to make a living on turnaround fadeaway jump shots. That is part of the reason she's 2 for 6. She spins away. That's a good feel for her, but is that something you can win a national championship on?
Well, my question would be, with all of her obvious skills, she is not very physical.
But I certainly think Rutgers would like to be as physical as they possibly can be. Essence Carson has a hard job to deal with her on the box.
Nearly thrown away, and now stepped out of bounds is Auguste on the sideline, the fifth Tennessee turnover. And Tennessee still hammering Rutgers on the board, 14-7. 8 of those 14 rebounds, offensive rebounds.
Yeah, the pace of this, despite that rebounding disparity, the pace of this game favors Rutgers right now. This is how they like to play. They shorten the game, try to get inside of 10, and then operate.
Ray had a good look and couldn't hit it. Here comes Hornbuck. Really good in the open court. Parker wanted it low, didn't get it against the double team. And a sickie. Hornbuckle wide open. She passed on the shot. They got it to Parker. Double team down low that time. She went for it.
Opportunistic. Kia Vaughn's absence. They just gave up a deuce because Junai did not finish, and they just gave up a deuce on the defensive end because she wasn't in there. That's a 4-point turnaround, and that's the margin.
Edgerbon threw it away. Somehow Essence Carson got it. Carson misses the jumper. Prince kept it alive. Then she loses it to Hornbuckle. Tied up. And it's a jump ball. Possession arrow gives it back to Rutgers.
Checking back in for Rutgers. Number 57, Kia Vaughn.
Vaughn will come back in. Junai will sit.
as much as Tennessee is working the post opportunities for Candace Parker, this is what I'd like to see from Rutgers. Neither team shooting a terrific percentage, Mike. You have mentioned the disparity in boards. But why are we not seeing Kia Vaughn get more opportunities on the box? Because we can contend with her physically from Tennessee.
Well, that's something they have said since this tournament began. They would like to see Kia Vaughn get more touches, and it never really seems to happen. There's one. She's double-teamed and fouled from behind by Hornbuckle.
One of the things they're doing is Sydney Spencer, who did a sensational job in the semifinals dealing with Erlena Larkins from North Carolina. They are fronting Kia Vaughn, so they're going to make you pass it over her size. Now look at her. That is a 6'3" body with long arms. That's part of the reason Vaughn is not getting touches.
Much harder to do than it is to say. It's like when you say a superstar ought to get 25 every game. Well, if you're double and triple team, it's a little harder to do it. You approach the 5-minute mark. There's a 3-pointer that won't go from Carson. Hornbuckle kicks it ahead to Parker. She's got that great second speed. Offensive rebound for Augusti. Partially blocked. Good feed to Augusti, and she scores. Good interior passing as Anasicki dumped it down low.
The size of Tennessee is having an impact on Rutgers right now. That's why the disparity and the points in the paint. Remember the report Holly Rowe did out of a 12-minute timeout. Points in the paint.
20-14, the biggest lead for Tennessee tonight. And Anasicki, a very accomplished passer from the top of the circle. Three won't hit for Carson. One and done for Rutgers.
Yeah, they're not pursuing the offensive glass at all.
Parker wanted it low. Instead, Anasicki. It looks like that. And there's another offensive rebound. Looks like that. You ought to be able to score. Spencer pull-up jumper. Nice.
Second chance opportunities. You give Tennessee multiple looks, and they are far too talented. You know, the usually sure-handed Rutgers team, are they starting to feel the pressure? They're so young. Look at this. Offensive rebounds, second chance points. That's the difference.
Adjavon has taken over before. Maybe she has to here, and a long pass thrown away. It will be out to Rutgers. There's a timeout with 3:28 to go first half. Tennessee by 6 as they play Rutgers for a national title.
So, John and I are thinking of going to Cancun if we can find a good deal.
That's funny. So are Dan and I.
It's time to play Take On Orbits. Today's players want a total vacation, hotel plus flight, and must save over $300. Go.
I need a deal to Cancun.
Oh, that's outrageous.
Done. Congratulations.
Thanks.
It's that easy. Next time, Orbits and go.
Buy you a Chevrolet. Go buy you a Chevrolet. If you give me some of your love.
Nobody can shut that Chevy down. Cause that brand new Chevy is mine.
I like my reach down. Am I top? You see me ride 24 in my Impala with.
No, we're not the jet set. We're the old Chevrolet set. But ain't we got love?
No, we're not the jet set. We're the old Chevrolet set.
Oh, I totally agree. I mean, you know, how much you have to invest these days to earn some respect. I mean, my broker takes forever to return my calls, and when he does, he's got like 2 seconds to talk. I mean, I realize the guy's got bigger fish to fry, but does he have to make it so obvious? Thank you.
Morning.
I appreciate someone who's willing to listen.
Hey! Check the air and the ball.
Someone I can count on for great coverage. That's why my go-to guy is my State Farm agent.
For car insurance, nobody matches State Farm's combination of personal service and low rates.
Even I can't argue with that.
Get a quote today and see how your insurance matches up to number one.
Like a good neighbor,
State Farm is there.
3:28 to go in the half. Tennessee with a 6-point lead. Let's check in with Holly Rowe.
Well, there's a familiar face in the crowd tonight, a former Duke player, Sheldon Williams, now playing with the Atlanta Hawks. He's here for good reason. His girlfriend, Candace Parker, is playing in her first national championship game. I asked him before the game, what's your advice for her? You've played on a big stage like this. He said, I just reminded her that all of her hard work has led her to this point, and to have the confidence to let it pay off, that she's put in the time, she's put in the work, and now she's reaping the benefit. He's making a sacrifice. The Atlanta Hawks practice tomorrow morning. He says he thinks he'll be there in time for shoot around, but if he's not, he will be fined between $2,500 and $5,000. So he thinks he's got it worked out, though, but he thought this sacrifice was worth it.
Well, that's when your girlfriend says, ooh, that's nice. That's right. Thank you.
That's as good as flowers. It might be
yes,
better.
Yes, it is. What a compliment. Here's the steal, Augusti, and she makes a great decision. One against two, she waited for help.
The usually sure-handed Rutgers team doesn't seem as aggressive in stripping the basketball or as solid with the basketball when they've got possession.
Parker, great pass.
We watched film with Tennessee earlier today, and you see Sarah Parker enjoying the passing skills. They talked a lot about that pass, Mike, that behind-the-defense pass. Rutgers is so in tune with the basketball, but sometimes they let their player get away from them.
And when you have somebody of that size, they can pass over the defense. Vaughn, again, gets it down low on the lob, and it's 24-18. Tennessee starting to play much better in the last 5 minutes. They have been passing on those outside shots. On another offensive rebound, Anasicki knocks it out to Parker. Spencer, got it! Second chance points are destroying Rutgers.
It's 13-2 in that category right now, and that's exactly where the difference in this ball game lies. The size of Tennessee. Nikki Anasicki came in with triple-digit offensive boards. Check out.
Epiphany Prince as we go under two. Tries to get down the lane, gets it to Zurich. Good outside shooter, but not that time. Knocked away out to the Lady Vols.
Now, Candace Parker has the most complete skill set of any player in the country. At 6'4", she sees right over the smaller Rutgers players and an easy deuce. And Sydney Spencer, the senior, would she step out in her final collegiate game and make shots? Number one on the jersey. That's a good-looking three.
Second chance points, Rutgers. Two. Tennessee with 13. Bobbitt will take her time as we're down to 140.
Yeah, danger time here as Rutgers looks like they're going into a... Nope, they're still playing man-to-man, just a little bit softer.
Spencer, another great pass, got it down low. Blocked this time, however, and now Spencer will get it back and fire. And an offense, or the rebound, goes to Junide. Boy, look at Prince. Prince trying to keep Bobbitt away from it so she can get it back, and it's a tie-up. But she could have picked it up again after she lost it.
Yeah, as long as you don't dribble it again, I'm not sure why she wouldn't pick it back up.
I think she was afraid it would be called a double dribble as she tried to pass it, but she could pick.
She could pick that up. She could absolutely pick that ball up.
That says it all, doesn't it?
This team just, you know, they started out the game. They looked fairly confident, ready to go. It was like Tennessee made a couple of shots, and then all of a sudden they lost their composure.
Parker, that time, a little bit too strong for Spencer. Let's go to Holly.
Well, guys, one of the rules this year, point of emphasis, is the coaching box and the decorum there. The assistant coaches from Tennessee were just jumping up and down, being very demonstrative. They've gotten a warning from the official, D. Kantner, or excuse me, it's not D, but one of the officials, and she told them they've got to calm it down, sit down on the bench. If they get another offense or another warning, it will be a technical foul.
All right, Holly, let's check in with Mark.
Yeah, guys, earlier this week, the Rutgers team in a timeout right now got a little jolt of championship karma. That's right. They ran into none other than Billie Jean King, arguably the best tennis player ever to play the game on the women's side of the ledger. They ran into her at a local steakhouse when they were having dinner. Now, King took the opportunity to address the team for about 30 minutes. She talked to them about taking cues on how to be a champion. looking for things in your opponents, their reactions, their eyes, and their posture, and especially knowing when to pounce. And when you look at Coach Stringer's record from school to school and now with Rutgers, guys, you would bet that some of those words that King said tied in a lot with some of the words that Stringer has told her team. Back to you.
All right, Mark. And Billie Jean was one of the great self-motivators of all time and really an example for other people in her sport. Jump shot short. 15-second difference between the game clock and shot clock. So Hornbuckle will give it up to Bobbitt, and it's been all Tennessee since the 10-minute mark. Parker one-on-one, drives, no bucket, but a foul. You can order copies of every complete game from the 2007 NCAA Division I Women's Championship through NCAA On Demand at NCAAsports.com, the official online home for all 88 NCAA championships. Parker at the line. The foul was on Junaid, her first.
I don't understand why Kia Vaughn remains on the bench again. She's only got one personal foul. Clearly, as soon as Tennessee saw that Rashida Junaid was on Candace Parker, they isolated her at the elbow and let Candace take her off the bounce from the high post. That's a sophomore on a freshman, but one of the most experienced, dangerous players in the nation. That's a bad matchup for Rutgers.
Well, it's like a shark smelling blood in the water. You're right. They see Vaughn's out of there, and it's right down the lane. Parker with 7 first-half points. Missed them both. Loose ball. There's the steal of Gusty. They were so worried about Bobbitt from behind. Parker, another good pass. And Gusty got it in the foul. Well, if Parker doesn't score again, she is already giving them a lot of value just as a passer.
Well, she's an unselfish player. She's patient. Look at the vision, the ability to see over the defense at 6'4", and the unselfish nature to give it up to Nikki Anasicki.
McCurdy got the last foul, her second. Anasicki missed it, almost got the rebound. And this will be a reach-in foul on Bobbitt.
It's a silly one, but it's only their 6th team foul.
And only her first. Now Pat Summitt wants a timeout with 8.4 seconds left. Coming up at the half, we'll check in with Trey Wingo for our halftime report. First half stats and analysis. Brenda Fries will join us on the set and Barry Bonds season debut. It's nice talking with Brenda earlier this evening. Did such a brilliant job a year ago winning a national championship for Maryland and fell short in the effort to repeat. Not many people repeat in anything.
That is a hard thing to do. Of course, Florida did it last night. Candace Parker has said she will return, so if she gets one tonight, she'll have a chance to do it again next year. At 6'4", the most complete package. She scores around the rim with great consistency. I like her vision. This fadeaway is tough. This is nothing you want to make your living on. But her ability to pass the basketball and her unselfish nature, she elevates the play of the people around her, and that's the mark of a great player.
Now Tennessee going to put a little pressure defense, so Rutgers may not get an easy shot. Adjavon, fadeaway jumper with 4 on the clock. And Rutgers, frustration may be starting to set in because they played so poorly in the last 10 minutes. Adjavon with 5, Parker with 7. As far as the Star Watch matchup, it's been Parker with the advantage, and Tennessee is a team with an 11-point lead. Here's Mark Jones.
Coach, what do you say at halftime to your team down by double figs like this?
We got to quit playing scared. We're very tentative. We act like we've never played before. So instead of us freezing cuts and setting screens, we're not doing it, just running everywhere instead of settling down. And it happens, it's got to start with the guard play right from the beginning. So, I know that it's difficult for us to see passes But the settle team that I've seen before is not happening. We're not even reading whenever there's traps, and it's causing all kinds of problems for us. Defensively, we're missing quite a few things that we would like to have done, and I think that we can get that changed in the second half.
Thanks a lot, Coach. Holly Rowe.
Well, Coach Summit, Rutgers makes so many teams uncomfortable in the first half of games. How do you feel your teams operated against them?
I think the one thing that's made us uncomfortable is that they're not guarding Nick Anasicki, and she's being really hesitant. And she has to go play her game, stay on the block. You know, she's trying to face up a little bit too much for my liking, and it's really taking us a little bit out of our rhythm. On a defensive end, I think we're doing a good job guarding their one-on-one game. I mean, they're really terrific in it, but overall, pleased with our defense.
All right, thanks, Coach. All right. Mike?
Right now, Holly, she should be pleased with everything because Tennessee is on top, 29-18 at the half. Let's join Trey Wingo.
All right, Mike, thanks very much. At the break, it is Tennessee in control by 11, 29-18. You saw the stat there this season, Tennessee 32-0. When they have the lead at the half, they have it at the national championship game. Trey Wingo along with Carol Lawson and Stacey Dales. Guys, you look at this contest. This is the pace, the kind of game that Rutgers wanted to play, but they're down double digits. Why?
Yeah, well, I think when you look at the first part of that first half, Rutgers did a good job of sagging off of, like Coach Summit said, Nick Anasicki and some of their perimeter players, really packing it in on Candace Parker, making entry passes difficult. But you know what they did the last 10 minutes? They really figured out the defense, and Candace Parker, with her size, was able to find open cutters. Sydney Spencer was able to hit some of those open perimeter shots. And that's the thing that the Tennessee offense did in this first half. They understood quickly what the Rutgers defense was trying to do. And Candace Parker is, of course, the center of it, and they're capitalizing on the gamble of bringing so many players over to Candace Parker.
Well, Karen, Trey, you just heard Pat Summit talk about the ability to defend one-on-one. That's the difference in this basketball game. I think Rutgers is the best defensive team in the country, but right now Tennessee is dominating at the defensive end. They are not allowing Rutgers to get any open looks. Rutgers, of course, came out in that last game against LSU, 80% from the three in the first half. Tennessee says, we're going to take you. We're going to trap you. They're not reading the traps, as Vivian talked about. And the difference right now, while you're defending the three-point line, you're also defending the paint. You're forcing those players into the paint where you have help waiting. Tennessee did not help in the first game to get here. They're helping tonight, Trey.
And the other thing, guys, is they are killing Rutgers on the offensive glass right now, getting so many second-chance points. You mentioned they shot 80% from deep in the semifinal. They have one three-pointer in the first half. Right now, it is an 11-point lead for Tennessee. When we return, Gail Gesten-Courts is leaving the ACC. Brenda Fries will join us to talk about that.
The NCAA Women's Championship, presented on ESPN by Orbitz, is brought to you by Marshalls. We can't drop names, but we can drop their prices. That's Marshall's Law. And Chevy, an American revolution.
After 89 years in the making, this is our truck. The 2007 Motor Trend Truck of the Year. The all-new Chevy Silverado.
Marshall's Law number 289. There's always room for shoes. Get the designers you crave at a price that lets you take twice as many home. Those who know Marshall's Law.
Hey, Steve.
Oh, hey, Rick.
You don't have Verizon Wireless.
Oh, it's this new thing. They're letting people test drive them for a month.
So far,
I'm a lot happier.
You guys never let me do that.
Rick, it's not what you think.
I think you're not as reliable.
Then it is what you think.
Now you can test drive America's most reliable wireless network. Try Verizon Wireless for 30 days. If we're not the best network you've ever had, take your number to one of the other guys, and we'll pay for the calls you made. Verizon Wireless.
What will you do?
Kill as many as I can.
After?
There'll be no after.
Pathfinder, Legend of the Ghost Warrior. Rated R for strong, brutal violence throughout. April 13th.
Guys,
are always looking for the next big thing, especially when it comes to the latest technology. Presenting Gillette Clear Gel Antiperspirant. With advanced triple protection system, it locks out odor, keeps you dry, makes you smell great all day. Gillette Clear Gel Antiperspirant. Triple protection technology for men.
Scouts are out early today.
There are over 380,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of them will be going pro in something other than sports. Download the guide for college-bound students at NCAAstudent.org.
At the break in the championship game, it is Tennessee in control. Candace Parker not exactly dominating, but doing enough, as the number one Lady Vols have a 29-18 lead over Rutgers. Big news away from this game. Gail Gestenkors is leaving Duke after 15 seasons and four Final Fours, and she will become the next head coach at the University of Texas, taking over for the retiring Jody Conrad. Welcome back to the Halftime Show. Trey, Kara, Stacy, and Brenda Freeze, ladies and gentlemen, head coach of University of Maryland. While I'm sure, Brenda, you're not upset that you don't have to play a Gail Gestenkors coach team two, three times a year, your thoughts on Gail leaving Duke and going to Texas?
Well, I tell you, I am upset because, you know, Gail, her team, they made us better. And ultimately, as a competitor, that's what it's all about. And, you know, we wish Gail and nothing but success. I know she'll do a tremendous job, but I'm sure Duke will have a more than suitable replacement with their reputation and their tradition. But I am truly surprised that she is going to Texas.
But she is going. So the question for you two now, what happened today? How did this process unfold, Stace?
Well, Trey, I talked to sports information director for the women's basketball team, Lindy Brown. He basically said that Gail Gestenkors met with Joe Oliva this morning, who is the athletic director at Duke, and they talked about the situation. She then met with her players. There was a lot of emotion in the room. The players shed some tears, of course. It was a very difficult, tumultuous week for Gail Gestenkors, but she was ready for a new challenge, and there's no question, Kara, this challenge will be a big one for her at Texas.
Yeah, I love the hire for Texas. I love the job for Coach Gail Gestenkors. You look at the state of Texas, it's a recruiting hotbed. There's a lot of great players in that state, and you look at this program. They missed the NCAA tournament the last 2 years. They have four of their top five scorers returning. I have no doubt that Gail Gestenkors can return the Texas program to national prominence.
The only time in Jody Conrad's career they missed the NCAA tournament two straight years. Okay, so deja vu, that sinking feeling, you've been here before. Last year in the national championship game, your Maryland squad down by 10 at the break. Tennessee now leading Rutgers by 11. What, if you're C. Vivian Stringer, do you say to your team at the half? Because whatever you said last year worked.
Well, you got to know that you're going to come out in the second half. You're going to play a lot better. The nerves now are out of their system. They're going to go out in the second half. They've got a rebound, obviously. And those are hustle plays, and Rutgers can make those plays. So it's a new half. You got to throw the last 20 minutes out and come out and be ready to put everything on the line for the next 20.
In their first half of the semifinal with LSU, Rutgers hit 8 3-pointers. In the second half, they hit 2. In this one, they only hit 1 in the first half. Can they shoot well enough to get back into this game?
Well, that's the big question, you know, whether they're going to be able to get enough attempts up. You know, I thought they were very effective off their dribble drive in the limited times that they were able to get it. But, you know, I think the biggest difference, they've got to make other opportunities for them, whether it's at the free throw line, being able to get more offensive rebounds, being able to block Tennessee out on the glass.
Maybe they should just get you in there and give the halftime speech, see if it works 2 years in a row. Brenda, thanks very much.
Thank you.
We appreciate it. At the break, it is Tennessee by 11. Keep in mind, not a lot of scoring for Nikki Anasicki, but boy, is she hustling. 8 rebounds. Kia Vaughn doing her part to keep Rutgers in it.
Hi, Enterprise. I'm at the repair shop, and I need to rent a car.
At Enterprise, we'll arrange to pick you up free and get you on your way.
Next day, Mom.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
The Lowe Senior Class Award honors achievement in competition, excellence in the classroom, community service, and outstanding character. Lowe's recognizes scholar athletes who are building a bright future for themselves and their communities. Lowe's, let's build something together. On behalf of the over 200,000 Lowe's employees, we congratulate Allison Bales of Duke University for for winning the 2007 Lowe's Senior Class Award for Women's Basketball.
Harvesting over 3 billion gallons of fresh water from the sea each year. Water desalination from GE.
We're all over it, not to worry. Yes, the team is with me, we got it covered.
Who's he talking to?
The boss.
I thought the boss was at a board meeting.
He is at a board meeting. They're asking about our global integration plan.
Do not worry.
Do we have a global integration plan?
It's more like a deck.
A deck?
A draft, really.
Deck is only a draft?
Afraid so.
It's not only doable, it's practically done. We better get started.
What will you do?
Kill as many as I can.
After?
There'll be no after.
Pathfinder, Legend of the Ghost Warrior. Rated R for strong, brutal violence throughout. April 13th.
Hoop fans, don't miss your chance to go to the 2008 Women's Final Four, April 6th and 8th, at the St. Pete Times Forum in Tampa. Log on to NCAASports.com to apply for your tickets online. That's NCAASports.com. And don't forget the 2008 Men's Final Four, April 5th and 7th, at the Alamo Dome in San Antonio. Log on to NCAASports.com to apply for your tickets online. That's NCAASports.com, the official website of the NCAA.
Hello, basketball fans. John Anderson here. We are back to Cleveland in a moment, but first, this Sports Center update. Barry Bonds getting his first spring swings of a new season opening day. Giants and Padres, the last two teams to have one. Bonds found the warning track, not the stands. Finished 1-for-3, still 21 homers behind Hank Aaron. Barry Zito loses his Giants debut. 7-zip is your final. Billy Donovan received the Siemens Trophy today, but says he hasn't received any calls from Kentucky about their coaching vacancy. Donovan says his itinerary for the week includes speaking at Marshall Wednesday, meeting with Florida AD Thursday, parade Friday, family vacation starting on Saturday. Also from the basketball world, John Beilein officially accepts the head coaching position at Michigan. And Dana Altman changed his mind. He's returning to Creighton. Had the Arkansas job yesterday, gave it back today. We now give it back to Trey Wingo for the second half out in Cleveland. Trey.
All right, John, thanks. Candace Parker not scoring in droves, but finding opportunities for others. It is the Lady Vols up by 11. Second half coming up in just a bit.
The NCAA Women's Championship is presented on ESPN by Orbitz. Save big at Orbitz.com. Just Orbitz and go. And in part by T. Rowe Price. Mutual funds, IRAs, college savings from T. Rowe Price. Invest with confidence.
So due to weather, our next departure is 6 a.m. tomorrow.
No, hey, lady.
It's time to play Take on Orbitz. Today's players have bad weather, must book a hotel before the other 200 passengers. Go.
Aquarius?
Yes.
Dentmore.
Oh, no vacancy. Orbitz TLC lets you find a hotel right from your phone. Next time, Orbitz and go.
Disciplined investing. It isn't about star fund managers. At T. Rowe Price, it's about experienced investment teams that stay the course. For each 1, 5, and 10-year period, 70% of our mutual funds beat their Lipper average. Low-cost mutual funds from T. Rowe Price. Invest with confidence. Request a complete prospectus or profile with investment objectives, risks, fees, expenses, and other information to read and consider carefully before investing.
There are 380,000 NCAA student athletes. And most of us
will go pro in something other than sports.
In something other than sports. Go to NCAAstudent.org to find out how.
unique as your fingerprint. Infinity. Express your individuality. Zimbrick Infinity of Madison.
Agent 24/7. Come.
New Prudential Real Estate Science.
No, with Yahoo. Very powerful. You'll need to reload.
More than usual.
Our exclusive relationship with Yahoo Real Estate has produced this. Now you can show your home sellers how many buyers are looking in their neighborhood, in their price range.
Even viewing their home online.
The future real estate is in your hands.
Prudential Real Estate and Yahoo together. The future of real estate now.
1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. 9, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock. We're gonna rock around 12 o'clock tonight. Put your glad bags on. Join me home. We'll have some fun when the clock strikes. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight.
At the half of the national championship game in Cleveland, Tennessee, with a lead over Rutgers, 29-18. Welcome back, everybody. Mike Patrick, Doris Burke, our entire ESPN crew. If Rutgers is going to come back and win this ballgame, they had better do a better job on the boards. They're just getting hammered.
Yeah, rebounding and the uncertain, tentative nature with which they played really cost them. One of the Home Depot coaching adjustments they're going to have to make is contending with Candace Parker, because her ability to pass the basketball hurt that team in the first half. They sent her off a stagger screen, and so much attention is being paid to where she is and when she catches the basketball. Watch what happens. Now, there's two Rutgers players, and they completely forget on the exchange that, guess what? They came off of one person, and that person gets a wide open layup because Candace is unselfish.
Offensive rebounds, 12-3. Assists, 7-2. So the fact that they both shot 37-38% doesn't make any difference.
Maya McCurdy has started the half in place of Heather Zurich. That gives them size, athleticism, and Zurich was rendered ineffective. Will McCurdy be more so?
Carson, pull-up jumper over Spencer.
And Rutgers comes with that vaunted 55, the staple of Vivian Stringer's system. Will it have an impact?
Foul is going to be called on Prince. That will be her
Rutgers
third.
Rutgers foul on Tiffany Prince. Her third personal, first team foul of this game.
She's coming off her best game of the tournament. For the first time we saw, we've been covering Rutgers for a while in this tournament, Doris, we saw them blink in the first half. They showed signs of cracking.
Yeah, this is a group that's composed of individuals with great character, but I think perhaps for the first time it dawned on a team with no seniors, boy, we're playing for a national title.
Parker baseline. She's in that close. She's going to score.
She has now got 11 points.
Adjavon. Offensive foul.
Well, their ability to get off the dribble tests your ability to come over in assistance and provide excellent help defense.
This foul will be on the 30. Her third.
Her third, team third.
Remember, Rutgers is not that deep.
That's correct. And two of their main people off the bench are freshmen. Pat Summitt reminded her unit of that in their film session earlier today.
Another offensive rebound. Parker, some contact, no whistle, and Parker knocks it down. Another good no call, it looked like.
Yeah, I like that. I mean, she might have used that left hand to push off, but she is just so skilled off the dribble and rise and fire. You will not block that shot.
Biggest lead of the game at 33-20. This is a danger zone for Rutgers. In spite of their great outside shooting in the semifinal, this is a team not built to come from behind in a hurry. Adjavon, nice cut down the lane, goes to the right hand, can't get the shot. And that's a foul on the rebound try as Adjavon got her hands on it.
Well, Candace Parker was named the Wake Trophy winner. There's talk that she's the best player college basketball has ever seen. How about the dribble between the legs by the 6'4" sophomore forward? That was pretty.
That one's out of bounds to Tennessee.
Go to Holly.
Well, we have seen Candace Parker put the ball on the floor like she's a small guard countless times. In fact, she's listed as a guard, forward, and center in their media guide. But one of the reasons she's so good with the ball is growing up, she first held the ball when she was 2 years old. She could walk at 8 months, so she was always very active. Her dad, Larry, knew she was going to be a tall kid because she was 50 inches tall in kindergarten. So he forced her, or suggested that she use both hands all the time and that she learn how to handle the ball.
Great training.
She's exceptional with either hand. She can make it around the rim with the left or the right, making it harder to check.
Spencer has one rim out. Vaughn with the rebound.
I think Rutgers needs to make a concerted effort to get Kia Vaughn some touches on the box. Sydney Spencer is facing her, but do something to get that powerful body open.
That would help. Rutgers once has come from 11 down. And there's Vaughn, and she missed a point-blank look. Got it back. Into the lane over at Parker. They have come from 11 down, but never this far this year. Anisicki against the double team. Bobbitt, good pass over to Hornbuckle. Tennessee concentrating so hard on the inside game. Here comes the double team on Parker. Nearly lost it. Saved by Bobbitt. Seven on the shot clock. Bobbitt. And she's fouled.
Well, Kia Vaughn was 3 for 5 in the first half. She finishes at a high percentage. She misses the chippy. A little mishandled by Hornbuckle, and that allows her a second chance opportunity. I think we still have to go to her and allow her to get some touches and see if she can be effective.
Foul was on Adjavon, her second. This Rutgers team is so unbelievably young.
Five freshmen, no seniors. The two most experienced players are Carson and Adjavon, the juniors.
Parker goes with a left hand. Can't hit that. Long with a rebound. Adjavon pushes it up. McCurdy got the roll.
Great play. She knew that a shot blocker extraordinaire was in her grill, so she gets it high off the window.
There's the trip. Bobbitt goes down hard. She got through three people, and the foul will be called on Adjavon. That's number three on Matee Adjavon.
That is a big call. They cannot win the basketball game if Matee Adjavon has to go to the bench.
Boy, they're throwing everything defensively they can at them, but if they don't get the ball away from Bobbitt, she's going to get through it. Crimson, McCurdy, and Adjavon all have three for CW Springer. Parker looks for that cutter first. Left hand just threw that one up there. Followed by Anisicki.
That's the good Vicki Anisicki.
And the basket will count.
For second, team six. There's a timeout on the floor.
15:57 to go for a national championship. The lead at 9.
Traffic ahead.
Incredible. You found a golf course near the conference. Awesome Chinese. Now you find me a way around traffic. I love you.
Turn around.
Every now and then I get a little bit lonely and you're never coming around.
Take Market Street exit.
You're right. We'll just keep it professional, you know?
Go everywhere, find everything. Fall hard for the new Wear 2 GPS at Avis.
Hello?
Melissa.
It's Josh from last night.
Oh, yeah, hey.
Listen, I know there's that two-day rule about calling or whatever, and this might sound totally dumb, but...
Did you feel like there was a real connection between us? I mean, you know, like a brother-sister connection? Nothing creepy. I mean, like, you know, I would never make out with my sister.
Singular is now the new AT&T. Your world delivered.
Now get the broadband razor for only $39.99.
Don't think of them as tools. This is not a saw, it's a deck. So we can grill out. And this is a shelf for our vacation pictures. And this,
okay.
This, okay, really?
It's the Home Depot Tool Event. Get an instant $35 to $500 off from power tools and wet dry vacs to generators and more, now through April 11th.
So this is my nice clean garage, right?
The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
I won't be scared of the playground anymore. I won't live in fear of runny noses. My immune system will fight back after the leukemia is gone. And I will laugh and smile and hold little Pete so tight. I'll never let him go.
Find the confidence to face any condition at Cleveland Clinic.
The whole state of Tennessee's counting on you.
Come on, baby.
The whole state of Tennessee's counting on you. You looked at the orange in this building? You know why they're here? For you and to help you win. But you're the ones that have to get it done, and you better make it happen starting right now.
You wonder how many times Pat Summitt has made that same speech, but she's got to deliver it every time like it's the first time she ever said it to make them believe it. And she did.
Yeah, there's conviction in that message. There's a real relaxed presence. She's a lighter individual. When you watch her on the sideline, you think she's so intense, but she's a lighter individual when you get to meet her personally and chat with her a bit.
Oh, she's a nice person. There's no doubt about that. She's a pretty good cheerleader, too, as she showed us earlier this year. And the sickie, no. Can't complete the three-point play. The lead is still 11. Vaughn. Double team got it anyway.
Every time she touches it, something positive happens back to Rutgers. They should just ride her. Look at that field goal percentage.
Brittany Ray is in for Rutgers. She contributed in a big way the other night.
And they're switching defenses now at 2-3. This is the first time they've run this. They're just trying to come up with different schemes to slow Tennessee down.
Got to look out for Bobbitt and Spencer. And long range. Shot clock at 3. Spencer sees it. Now has to fire under pressure. Offensive rebound, Anasicki right in the middle of 3 Scarlet Knights.
Pat Summitt talked about Nikki Anasicki being anxious on the offensive end, but on the glass, she's been superb.
She has 11 rebounds tonight, 7 on the offensive end. She is dominating. Spencer, too strong. Spencer kept it alive, but committed the foul over the back of Brittany Ray. That will be 3 on Sydney Spencer. Pat Summitt going for her 7th national championship, and she has a 9-point lead. The Rutgers Scarlet Knights going for their first. Can they come from behind? Second chance points say no, they can't, because Tennessee, 16 offensive rebounds would have resulted in 17 points. That's obviously the difference in this ballgame.
Now, Kia Vaughn is checking out of the basketball game, has checked out. Now, she just scored. Whatever Vivian Stringer is telling her, it's got to be something important, because she's been their best weapon offensively.
We've got Junaid back in the game. Junaid has been a liability defensively. Adjavon kicks it out. McCurdy, a brick. Ray, offensive rebound. Junaid.
No, that touched rim. It looks like Michael Price is saying he's tapping his head as if that's a shot clock violation, but I thought that touched orange on the second shot.
I did too.
It has to touch orange. It doesn't on the first, clearly.
This one did. I mean, that's tough to miss that one. All right, the shot clock won't reset for that. Now they're going to call it an invert whistle. And Rutgers will get the ball back. There really didn't result in any Rutgers points because they did not score on the third shot.
So Lisa Mattingly going to give clarification to both coaches?
That would seem to be a fair rule.
That's correct, because Rutgers had possession. They made the shot. It was at that point the horn went off because there was no reset. So this is exactly what should happen.
But there's 29 seconds on the shot clock. That's the only part of that I would question.
No, what should happen, Mike, they got the third shot, so about 1 second went off. The clock
That's
is
right.
appropriate.
Yeah, you're right. One of the few breaks Rutgers has gotten for second chance points opportunity. They need to take advantage of it. Kia Vaughn back in. Carson picked up her dribble. 8 on the shot clock. Tenacious defense by Tennessee. Hornbuckle will pick up her second foul, fighting through that screen.
I like that, though. They were so aggressive in denying the basketball. Pat Summon has got to applaud the effort of Hornbuckle. She's trying to keep it out of Ajvon's hands.
Third team foul on Tennessee. Rutgers has committed 6.
Now Tennessee goes zone, challenges Rutgers to make shots.
Three-pointer is bricked out of the corner by Ray, but there's the follow. 12 points for Kia Vaughn and a whistle.
Now, Kia Vaughn continues to be a force inside. Sidney Spencer looks like maybe changes the trajectory of that shot, and Vaughn, the offensive putback. Good stuff by Kia.
It was a delay of game warning on Ajvon for slapping the ball after the basket. Players love to do that so they can set their defense.
Just 7.
35-28, you're right. Can they make a run? Sicky was wide open. They finally covered up on the double team. Zurich got a piece of the block. Offensive rebound to Spencer.
Size at every position.
Shot clock did not recycle, of course. Another offensive rebound. Bob it out of the corner, and that's a killer. Credit Candace Parker with the offensive rebound on the last sequence.
It is not enough for you to go ahead and try to out-jump Tennessee. They've got too much size and skill. You've got to put a body on somebody, Mike, and back them out of the paint.
Vaughn wants the ball. They get it to her against Parker. It's a tough shot for her, and it rattles in and out. Bobbitt launches another 3. Tipped out of bounds by Tennessee. Now the officials looking at each other.
As it should be. Yeah, you know what? Michael Price, I think, had the better view of that. It looked like Tyna Napier was trying to convince him otherwise, but he was solid in his conviction that it was going to go to Rutgers.
12-14 to go in this championship game, and a 10-point lead against Rutgers is big because they take so much time on every possession. If they score at the normal rate, they're not going to get that many possessions. Ajvon can't hit the 3. And they don't get any second-chance opportunities. Bobbitt kicks it back out. Spencer. Bobbitt wide open. Got it! Another dagger in the heart.
Great ball movement. I mean, that is Candace Parker looking to distribute on the fast break. The floor was spread. Rutgers just does not have the same swagger, the confidence, the persona that had rattled so many opponents.
Bobbitt got it away from Ajvon. Hornbuckle, great head fake.
You got to get a timeout right now. This has gotten away from you. Your team has got no confidence at this point if you're Vivian Stringer. Get a timeout.
The lead has grown to 15, the biggest of the game. And Rutgers' dreams of a national championship starting to slip away.
Shannon Bobbitt is starting to rain threes from all over the floor. She distributes to Sidney Spencer, who gives it right back. And this Tennessee team looks very confident. Pat Summit saying, get back on defense. Hornbuckle gets out in the open floor. Nice hesitation.
The new Pontiac GXP Performance Series isn't faster than the speed of light, but it is faster than a Porsche Boxster and a BMW X5. The Pontiac GXP Performance Series, designed for action.
Pedicure, $28 on debit MasterCard. Peep toe pumps to show off your pedicure, $96 on debit card. Adorable dress to go with your peep toe pumps that show off your pedicure, $150 on debit card. Yeah, right. Living in the moment, priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For everything you must have right now, there's debit MasterCard.
If you could travel like this, for the same price as this, why wouldn't you?
It's the same with auto insurance. With discounts up to 40%, it's possible to get the personal service of a State Farm agent for the same or less than those other guys. Call an agent 24/7 or visit statefarm.com.
You give a little love, and it all comes back to you.
You're gonna be remembered for the things that you say and do. You give a little love, and it all comes back to you.
ESPN's coverage of the 2007 NCAA Women's Championship is broadcast in high definition and presented by Olivia. The last time Rutgers won a national championship was in 1949. They shared it with Army in fencing. Tonight might have been the night to snap that long streak, but right now they'll need their best comeback of the season to accomplish it.
Let's give some credit to the offensive rebounding ability and the defense. Tennessee, we talked a lot about Rutgers' defense. How about Tennessee? 28 points on the board with 10-plus remaining.
They have been brilliant. Adjavon with a miss. Offensive rebound, a rare one for Rutgers, but the miss by Carson before Parker kicked it out of bounds.
There's a timeout on the floor.
Timeout. 10:40 to go in the championship game. The lead is 15.
The new Pontiac GXP Performance Series isn't faster than the speed of light, but it is faster than a Porsche Boxster and a BMW X5. The Pontiac GXP Performance Series, designed for action.
Now, who can tell me how much distance we need to keep between ourselves and the car in front of us? Mr. Light.
Just enough to get a good draft, I guess. 2 or 3 inches?
Correct. And, no way, you mean 2 or 3 seconds?
Seconds for what?
Seconds behind.
I'm not getting 2 or 3 seconds behind anybody.
You mean inches?
NASCAR Busch Series at Nashville. Telecast presented by Tractor Supply Company. Saturday on ESPN.
Do you have credit problems? Come to Capital Auto Credit or Madison Auto Credit, where your job is your credit. Listen to these special buys. Now get a 2005 Chevy Impala for just $62 a week. You can drive a 98 Chevy Blazer for only $49 a week. Or choose a 2005 Mercury Sable for just $62 a week. We'll get you into the car, truck, or minivan you want. See us today. Capital Auto Credit, East Washington at Highway 30. Madison Auto Credit, next to American on the Beltline at Todd Drive.
Selling your vehicle online at carsoup.com is like having your own personal sales kiosk inside the area's largest automotive super shopping center. Put full color pictures and unlimited information on display for thousands of local buyers. Turn for sale into sold super fast. Sell your truck, boat, motorcycle, or car where the shoppers are for only $25 till it sells at carsoup.com. Now that's a super deal. Buy, research, sell. carsoup.com.
If you're thinking three-pointers that would help a Rutgers comeback, they were only one out of six tonight. Remember, against LSU in the first half, they were 8 out of 10. They could certainly use a hot streak like that, Doris.
Well, here's the difference. Most teams in this tournament conceded that shot to Vivian Stringer's team. They thought, you know what, they cannot consistently knock down the jump shot. The difference for Tennessee is they're putting all kinds of pressure on those shooters. They're not conceding anything. And that's why that 1-for-6 has happened tonight.
Great coaching move by Pat Summitt. She saw what happened. 8 out of 10. A huge boost. Vaughn against the double team. She's fouled.
Tennessee foul.
Wow. Wouldn't mind seeing that one again. If she could get up, and she blocks either with either hand, Candace Parker.
And the line for two shots, number 15, Kia Vaughn.
Does have some physical skills, doesn't she? Vaughn's been the big offensive weapon for Rutgers tonight, 12 to 28.
Well, we get the benefit of the second look. You know, Candace Parker is an outstanding shot blocker. Yeah, that's an absolute foul, no question. Ooh, she can't believe it. Has there ever been a player who's admitted to a foul?
Not one. Vaughn hits them both. 43-30. Parker will help on the press with such a good ball handler. And she can throw to the top of the defense. Bobbitt hits another three. Holy cow, she had a big second half. Bobbitt has a dozen.
Her 4-3, she has been so confident, the smallest player, but her teammates say she's got the biggest heart.
At 5'2", she is the shortest player ever offered a scholarship in the Southeastern Conference. Vaughn got it back. Got it back again, and walked.
Now, Shannon Bobbitt, a New Yorker who played with Epiphany Prince on a couple of state championships. And Vivian Stringer just absolutely disgusted.
Tennessee in complete command at this point. They've done a great job with that high-low passing. And Bobbitt's starting to feel it now. Misses that one. Good job by Prince to come under control. And Bobbitt would have taken another one away from him. 9:09 to go.
And now they start to try and get in front of Kia Vaughn, force the lob pass with Candace Parker waiting to give some assistance.
The outside game is going to have to work. Prince drives and draws a foul.
Tennessee foul on Candace Parker.
That's on Parker. That's number two on Parker. Prince at the line. She was a leading scorer for this club until a couple of weeks ago. Lost it, nearly regained it. Vaughn has assumed that mantle.
You know, Mike,
Prince misses.
Before the LSU game, when we met with C. Vivian Stringer, there was an incredible level of confidence. There was great conviction that they could beat LSU. Mm-hmm. When we met with Vivian Stringer the other day, I didn't have that same sense that she was as confident that they could beat Tennessee.
Would you be confident playing Tennessee?
Not with a woman who has won 900-plus games and six titles. I'd be a little bit nervous.
No, she doesn't inspire confidence against her. Hornbuckle wide open. No. Offensive rebound. Boy, has Anna Sicky been a monster on the board.
Rutgers foul on Epiphany Prince.
Fouls on Prince. That's four on the freshman out of New York.
At the line for
14 rebounds for Anna Sicky, only one short of her best game this year.
It's their 19th offensive rebound of the game.
Good time to step up, huh? Misses the free throw, and the problems continue to mount for Rutgers as Prince will have to sit down with her fourth personal. See, Vivian Stringer won't be able to leave her there for very long. Bet on that. Second is no good. Look at Bobbitt. 5-2. She gets an offensive rebound. Adjabon dribbles out of trouble. Sure, good head fake to get open and then makes the shot from 18 feet.
You're going to have to start coming with some pressure and get them to turn it over. This is a team that's got to start to get some of its swagger back. And you got to do it pretty soon, Mike. This game is close to being over.
Well, if Shannon Bobbitt is going to get offensive rebounds against you at 5-2, it is over. Parker didn't get the roll on that one. Rutgers is not going to be able to follow this familiar pattern of if they don't score early to take it down to 10 seconds. They don't have that luxury anymore.
No, what is Tennessee doing? They're pushing up early to make sure they're not getting transition points.
Vaughn, good fake, but called for travel. Timeout, 7:34 to go for a national title. It's Tennessee by 13.
Not good.
The board's asking questions.
Hard questions.
About our global integration strategy.
Global integration strategy?
You know, the world is flat.
Do we have a strategy for that?
That's what they want to know. Oh, no.
Not good.
They're looking for innovation.
A plan.
A schedule.
Answers.
Soon.
Yesterday.
No.
Oh, boy.
Oh, no.
Not good.
What do we do?
Traffic ahead.
Incredible. You found a golf course near the conference. Awesome Chinese. Now you find me a way around traffic. I love you.
Turn around. Every now and then I get a little bit lonely and you're never coming around.
Take Market Street exit.
You're right. We'll just keep it professional, you know?
Go everywhere, find everything. Fall hard for the new Wear 2 GPS at Avis.
So he sent me the most beautiful bouquet ever.
What'd the card say?
Only something beautiful for my something beautiful.
Oh, that's so sweet.
I know. Everyone here has been joking. He must have done something really bad. You don't think he could have... Oh.
Singular is now the new AT&T. Your world delivered. Now get the broadband razor for only $39.99.
Time for the Pontiac game-changing performance of the tournament. Had to be the second-half comeback of Tennessee against North Carolina, outscoring them 20-2 to advance to the final. For their efforts, Pontiac will donate $5,000 to the Tennessee General Scholarship Fund. Thank you, Trey Wingo. 7 minutes, 34 seconds to go in this game. Tennessee in command with a 13-point lead.
And Rutgers pushing up on the pressure now, just going to try to make some turnovers. Thus far, Tennessee one turnover in the second half. They've handled everything Rutgers has thrown at them.
So tough to get Bobbitt in any kind of trouble. She's so quick. You want somebody who can keep the dribble low to the floor. Well, she starts that way.
Yeah, she's her center of gravity. It's hard to strip her where the ball is being bounced off the floor.
Shot clock down to five. Spencer to the baseline. She's got a pretty looking jump shot. and gets the shooter's touch.
Well, that's the perfect possession when you've got this kind of lead. The shot clock was well inside of 10. You got a quality look along the baseline from somebody who's got great size at 6'3". I think the size has been a real issue for Rutgers.
McCurdy and Brittany Ray are both in there for Rutgers right now. Let's go to Mark Jones.
Hey guys, during the last timeout, Vivian Stringer spoke to her squad about ratcheting up the pressure defensively, and you saw them come out a little three-quarter court, half-court type of trap. But at the offensive end, she really stressed working inside to that lady right there, Kia Vaughn, and looked at Essence Carson right there and said, the time is now. Start making some shots. Back to you guys.
Well, the time is now, Mark. Maybe beyond now. Hornbuckle kicks it out to Bobbitt.
Rutgers in a 2-3 zone. This allows Tennessee to simply pass around until it gets inside of 10.
Sure does. Tied up here. They do get a steal off of it. Here comes Adjamar. And she is fouled by Anna Sitchin. And it's an excellent point, Doris. When you have to strip the ball, go for steals, it's just hard to imagine they're in a zone right now. The lowest point total ever scored in a championship game, 44 by Louisiana Tech. That was against Tennessee. Rutgers is going to have to go to get to 44. Ray. And Asiki tries to save, and it's out of bounds.
Well, Nikki Anasuki, I thought she saved them in the semifinal. She was doing a terrific job scoring, rebounding, setting screens, blocking shots. You see the offensive rebounding disparity. She's been a huge force tonight on the backboards and been the major factor in that offensive rebounding differential.
Don't see a lot of sense of urgency from the Rutgers offense right now. Zurich gets the ball, missed. Kialan scores and she'll draw a foul. I know you don't want to panic, but you do have to hurry.
Yeah, you have got to have as efficient an offensive set as you can get. You've got to go in the first 10 seconds. Zurich, a little free throw line jump shot. Vaughn has been sensational all night.
They gave the foul to Spencer. That's four on Spencer. 16 points for Vaughn. Doesn't get the bounce on the free throw. 5:48 and counting. The lead is 13. No pressure on Bobbitt as she brings it up. Vaughn, 7 out of 13. The rest of the team, a lot of bricks.
Good patience against the zone. Ball has moved side to side. You've gone inside out.
Of course, they don't have to score.
No, they could simply offer. Look at Anasuki again.
Bad pass that time by Hornbuckle. You have to wonder what she was thinking. Cross-court pass picked off by Tennessee. Hornbuckle. Baseline jumper and got it.
Alexis Hornbuckle for Tennessee.
Boy, Tennessee has been terrific tonight.
Yeah, there is no energy coming whatsoever from this Rutgers team. This team is not a team that has belief that it can win this basketball game right now.
Zurich knocks it down. Here comes the defensive pressure, finally. But look at him drop back. Doris, I just don't get this.
Yeah, I'm not sure why she's going with this, because this is a team that needs to make turnovers, and the way you do that is to press at the trap and to play man-to-man. But that last graphic, remember what we said at the start of this telecast, Mike? Somebody besides Parker had to make shots. 33 between Bobbitt and Spencer. There was your answer.
Parker fadeaway. And Asiki with another offensive rebound. And you look at the defense Rutgers is playing right now. They're virtually conceding the ball game.
Yeah, I mean, this is a team that has had great belief in its ability to beat its opponents. From the outset tonight, it was a team that lost its swagger.
Shooting 1-1 for Tennessee, Nikki Anasuki.
Anasuki at the line, 6'4 junior out of Staten Island, New York. 16 rebounds, 10 of them on the offensive end. A season high for Nicky Anasicki. Vaughn kicks it out, the long jumper to Carson. Had a toe on the line. It's a two-point jumper. Tennessee will call a timeout at the 3:44 mark.
It's a 30-second timeout.
It's about the press bait from this point forward. And the best option they have, Mike, is get the ball to Candace Parker at 6'4 in the middle of the floor and let her just look over the defense.
Go to Holly Rowe. Holly.
Well, Tennessee had a turning point in their season. It was a 9-point loss in the SEC semifinals to LSU. They were embarrassed. Candace Parker had a career-low 4 points, and they had a team meeting after that. Nicky Anasicki was the leader in that meeting, and Candace Parker said, she let me have it. She let me know that I had let the team down and that I needed to get my act together. Anasicki was the leader and had them all write down what their roles would be for the rest of the year. Nicky said, I needed people to define what they could be held accountable for. You saw them there. Simple things like Candace needed to play both ends of the floor. Nicky needed to be the defensive stopper. They believe they have held to those roles, and the postseason has been a different story.
And you know what, Holly Rowe, last year Pat Summitt said, I knew we couldn't win a championship. There was no chemistry. There was some jealousy on the team. You sensed from her yesterday that she believed this team had a title in it.
And again, no defensive pressure from Rutgers. Now, finally, there is a 3:23 for Anasicki. 16 rebounds, 10 of them on the offensive end. Those are both career highs. What a brilliant way to finish the season with a career performance in the national championship game. Zurich short on the jumper. Parker with a rebound. Kicks it ahead to Hornbuckle. And this is all Tennessee needs to do.
Just space the floor. Make sure you do not shoot it inside of 10. I don't understand the zone. Again, you've got to come out and trap and press, start fouling if you have to.
No, it's mind-numbing to me that you're down to 11 and you're playing that kind of defense. Adjavon knocks down a three. It's a huge shot for her and gives Rutgers some hope.
And now they push up with the pressure.
Pat Summitt says, run the offense.
This possession can get you down to 2 minutes.
Parker slashes in. Another offensive rebound and a fresh 30. You're not going to get it away from Bobbitt very often. Unless you get over the 5-second call. Hornbuckle under 2 minutes. Leans into it. Offensive rebound, Parker in the foul.
Now, Pat Summitt has won 6 titles. Very often, they were the most dominant rebounding team in the country when they did it. She called this one of the worst rebounding teams in her history, but they focused on it in the postseason. They are now +8. And tonight, the difference in this game has been their ability to offensive board it. There have been white jerseys pounding the glass night after night. It has resulted in multiple second-chance opportunities. And Tennessee is a minute and 45 from giving Pat Summitt number 7.
John and I are thinking of going to Cancun, if we can find a good deal.
It's funny. So are Dan and I.
It's time to play Take on Orbits. Today's players want a total vacation, hotel plus flight, and must save over $300. Go.
I need a deal to Cancun.
Oh, that's outrageous. Done.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
It's that easy. Next time, Orbits and go.
This new fridge has a touch screen. I get internet, TV. The coolest part of it is when it's out of Bud Light, it refills itself.
How does it do that?
I don't know.
Refreshingly smooth Bud Light. Always worth it.
I don't know how it does it, and I don't care.
What will you do?
Kill as many as I can.
After
after?
There'll be no after.
Pathfinder, Legend of the Ghost Warrior. Rated R for strong, brutal violence throughout. April 13th.
The Lowe Senior Class Award honors achievement in competition, excellence in the classroom, community service, and outstanding character. Lowe's recognizes scholar athletes who are building a bright future for themselves and their communities. Lowe's, let's build something together. On behalf of the over 200,000 Lowe's employees, we congratulate Allison Bales of Duke University for winning the 2007 Lowe's Senior Class Award for women's basketball.
Ahead on SportsCenter, a big surprise in the Giants opener. What the Packers should do in the draft to help Brett Favre. Plus why Pac-Man Jones could reportedly miss half the season after the game.
The NCAA Women's Championship presented on ESPN by Orbitz is brought to you by Pontiac, the official performance machines of the NCAA.
Elvis was in the first class in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame 1986. It also included Chuck Berry, James Brown, Ray Charles, Fats Domino, and Buddy Holly. That's a pretty good class to be in.
Candace Parker at the line.
Love Ray Charles. Love his music.
Parker at the line. A 16-point lead has been cut in half. Parker's so smooth. Only two out of five tonight from the line.
Let's go, let's go.
52-42. Her mom and her boyfriend, Sheldon Williams.
Got to be really efficient here. As many quick hitters as you can score on.
And Javon. Bobbitt. Triple teamed out of bounds to Tennessee. Even triple team, you think she's going to get out of it.
Her dribble is so low to the ground, it's almost impossible to strip her.
And the city will inbound.
You have got to start fouling if you do not get a quick strip. You have got to make this game as long as you can. There it is.
And Parker draws the foul from Carson.
Rutgers foul on SS Carson.
Rutgers,
that's her third.
Yeah, they did a heck of a job shooting threes. When they make shots, they are tough to beat. Tonight, they were unable to, Mike. And I think that has to do with the strategy of Tennessee coming out and pressuring them from the outset.
10 out of 20 in the semifinal, but the bigger story was 8 out of 10 in the first half. And Parker will go to the line. Check in with Holly.
Well, there's been so much talk that Candace Parker may declare for the WNBA draft and leave school early. Tennessee has released a statement saying they believe that she is not eligible because she will not graduate until May 2008. She has said she's coming back to school. Her coach, Pat Summitt, said she's believed that she's coming back to school. But some sources have said that there is big money for Candace Parker out there if she would declare early for the WNBA, not just in endorsements, big money to play in Russia or Korea as Kiavon scores there. Big decision for Candace Parker coming up.
Now the big money is overseas, particularly in Russia, where they're willing to pay a ton for players.
Yeah, between $600,000 and $1 million. This is an unprecedented situation in the history of women's college basketball. Clearly, with Sylvia Fowles and Candace Parker, much of the talk centered around whether either of those two would declare early.
She's shooting two.
Sylvia Fowles is out of the draft. She had to declare by 5 p.m. the day after she lost. Candace Parker would have until 10 a.m. tomorrow, but Holly's point is an important one. If she is not on track to graduate in the year she wishes to be drafted, she is ineligible.
Parker has built the lead to 11 with only 108 to go. Make it 12. And Rutgers wasted so much time in that zone defense and allowing Tennessee to burn one possession after another off the shot clock. And there's a pass to Kia Vaughn, too strong by Prince. And really, at this point, two-pointers aren't going to do you any good either.
Nope. It's going to be a hold before any time goes off.
Boy, and Zurich just reached out and grabbed Auguste and wouldn't let her go. Auguste wants an intentional foul and was upset about it. And that should have been called an intentional foul. If you grab somebody like that just with the idea that you're going to create the foul, you're not making a play on anything. And obviously, they're going after a 65% free throw shooter in Alberta Auguste.
And Pat and Candace sharing a smile. It's extraordinary what Pat Summitt has done. She's averaged 28 wins per year over 32 years. This is her seventh season with 33-plus wins. She's on the verge of a seventh national title that would put her three behind the legendary John Wooden.
And if you say, how many Sweet 16s have you been to? You can say, how many have there been? I've been to all of them. Carson under pressure, Parker fouled her, and fouled her behind the three-point line. It's the last thing they want is to stop the clock and foul a three-point shooter. The numbers on Summitt, this would be number seven. Gino Auriemma has won five.
She's shooting two.
So that is exclusive company.
Now the thing about it is, she is a young woman who could coach easily for another 15 years. You had mentioned on the semifinal night, it's possible she could get to 1,000 wins before she gets to 200 losses. That's incredible.
Just a remarkable record. Free throw won't go, and Rutgers down to its last gasps at this point. Carson, a 76% free throw shooter. Had a great game against LSU, 15.6 rebounds. Eight tonight. Misses the first two. Dominique Redding will come in for Tennessee. To get her name in the scorebook as Anna Sicke goes out and gets a standing ovation from the Tennessee crowd and a few other people as well. She was brilliant in the middle.
I thought she was her MVP in the semifinal. You could make a case for her being the MVP tonight. And Redding, a senior, nice gesture by Pat Summitt to get her in the game.
Kia Vaughn hits the shot after three consecutive missed free throws. This is Bobbitt. They're trying to foul her. They have to catch her first. Good luck on that one. It took about 5 seconds.
Rutgers foul number 22.
Foul will be on Adjavon. That's her fourth. We'll take a look at tonight's player of the game, brought to you by Powerade and Candace Parker with 17.6 boards and 3 assists.
She's got her national title. We said at the start of this ball game that her legacy was on the deck. She asked not to be included with Shamika Holzblum, Tamika Catchings as the all-time greats at Tennessee until she had a title to her credit.
Bobbitt knocks this one down. The rare junior college transfer into Pat Summitt's program. Well, Parker, whether she stays in school another year or not, with a brilliant future in professional basketball, maybe back next year for another championship. Bobbitt nearly swiped that one. Carson can't hit it, and another rebound to Parker. Shot clock is off. For the seventh time in their brilliant history, and for the seventh time in Pat Summitt's exceptional career, Tennessee wins a national championship.
Vivian Stringer will be back. No seniors on that roster, but Pat Summitt is the preeminent coach in women's college basketball, and she just continues to add to her legacy.
Another remarkable achievement for Tennessee. They have not won a championship since 1998. The drought is over.
Obviously on the defensive end, and I just felt like defense and board play. Nick Anasicki was just unbelievable on the boards.
Getting kisses.
Obviously, I'm really proud of him. I know in postseason sometimes your offense is not as sharp, but defense is all about heart and desire, and so is rebounding, and they really bought into those two aspects of the game.
Coach, this team had to take a hard look at themselves before this offseason started. What do you think they saw, and how did they change it?
Well, I told them championships are won in the offseason, and it would define who we are and where we're going based on how hard they were willing to work, because obviously they had to do that on their own. It was amazing when I saw them in the fall, the level of commitment they made in the weight room and on the court and working on their skills. And they're a much better team, and I feel like they deserve this because they certainly worked for it.
All right, let's check in with Mark Jones, who's with Candace Parker. Thanks, Coach.
Candace, congratulations, first of all. There's been so much hype surrounding your career since the time you were a senior in high school and the time at Tennessee, your 2 years. How much does this championship mean in terms of validating your collegiate career?
I don't even care about that. I just wanted to win a national championship, and this team did that. Our banner is going to be in the rafters for forever, and we left our mark on Tennessee.
Your passing was a big factor early. How much of that was a concerted effort by you to go into the game and make things happen that way?
You know, I like to say pick your poison with our team, because we're capable of scoring from different positions. If they take one thing away, then we're able to do four more.
Shannon Bobbitt had an outstanding night. Why was she so big for you guys this evening?
She's been huge all year. She was a great addition to our team, and you know, she's big in size.
Can media members like myself start including your name with the likes of Holsqua and other greats that have played at Tennessee now?
I don't know. That's up to y'all.
What does it mean to be able to win this in front of your family members here tonight?
This means everything. It means everything in the world. Knoxville was due for a championship. It's been 20 years since we won our first championship, and, you know, things repeat themselves.
All right, congratulations, Candace. Mike, back to you.
All right, Mark Jones, thank you very much. Our thanks go out to Phil Dean, our producer, our director, Chip Dean, John Madry, and Fred Kiger for all their wonderful stat work throughout the regionals and here at the finals. For my partner Doris Burke, Holly Rowe, and Mark Jones, this is Mike Patrick. We thank you for watching tonight, everybody. We had a great weekend here in Cleveland. Let's go back to Trey Wingo. Trey?
All right, Mike, thank you very much. As the confetti rains down, hey, we're all part of the party now. Tennessee is back on top, Rocky Top, for the seventh time in Pat Summitt's career, reaching the pinnacle, winning the national championship tonight in Cleveland. Joined by Carol Lawson and Stacey Dales. And guys, first look at the score, really what Rutgers wanted to do, 59 points. It was almost as if tonight, guys, Tennessee decided to say, we're going to out-Rutgers Rutgers.
Yeah, I think when you look at the ability of Candace Parker and all the attention that she draws, double teams and triple teams, her ability to pass out of those, find open teammates, and the support players that hit big shots, Shannon Bobbitt and Sydney Spencer. And how about Coach Pat Summitt? She wins her seventh title. She's been the best coach in women's college basketball her entire career, Stacey, and she just keeps on adding to that tremendous legacy.
Jack Carrick, Candace Parker, and Pat Summitt were phenomenal in this game, but this game really shows me that the team chemistry really went out in basketball, in any realm of sports. Back on January the 5th, Nikki Anasicki, who in my mind was the MVP of this tournament, she created a pact. She had all the players sign it. Basically, that pact said, you need to be a great teammate, and you need to commit yourself to this Tennessee program. They did that. That was the day, if you recall, they beat Tennessee,
UConn.
Connecticut,
yeah,
on another six.
And they have certainly rolled since then. Now, Kara, I have to ask you, as a part of the past of this proud tradition of Tennessee, what does this mean to you quickly?
I'm really happy for Coach Summitt, and you know, you talk all the time, Tiger Woods recreates his swing, and he's big enough to do that. I think the humility of Coach Summitt She recreates her program year in and year out and has the ability in this new age to still communicate with players and win at the highest level.
Well, she doesn't have to answer the question anymore. How come you haven't won one since 1998? That one is gone. It is party time in Knoxville and in Cleveland. When we return, Mark Jones will have the trophy presentation.
Of fencing and 3 years of law school teach you a lot. For him, it's confidence. For me, it's pride. Go to NCAAstudent.org to find out how your child could become one of the many student athletes who go pro in something other than sports.
If these walls could talk, they'd say with field goal posts this narrow, threading the needle is not always done with your hands. If these walls could talk, they'd say you have to see it to believe it. Russell Athletic, ESPN Arena Football, Monday at 7:30 p.m. on ESPN2.
Ahead on SportsCenter, a big surprise in the Giants opener. What the Packers should do in the draft to help Brett Favre, plus why Pac-Man Jones could reportedly miss half the season after the game.
I can show tonight. Game time. Let's do this thing.
The all-new full-size 2007 Toyota Tundra, the truck that's changing it all. Available now at your Toyota dealer.
Certified pre-owned at Zimbrick BMW. Financing and lease specials available from BMW FS.
When your child gets sick with the usual illnesses an unusual number of times, it could be an immune deficiency called PI. Get the warning signs.
The sparkle from the confetti matches the sparkle in the eyes of the Tennessee players. Candace Parker, your most outstanding player as Tennessee for the seventh time in Pat Summitt's amazing career, number one in all of college basketball. Welcome back, Trey Wingo here with Carol Lawson and Stacey Dales. And you just have to look at the symmetry of what she has done here. 20 years, Stacey, after Pat Summitt won her first national championship, she wins her seventh.
Yeah, it really is remarkable. And again, Kara made this point before the break. She is the most humble individual to have seven championships and to say to us before this game that she doesn't have all the answers, that she actually defers to her players more than she ever has to get insight from them in the huddles. That's really unique to me and really special that she's been able to accomplish that in her tenure.
Did she do that when you were her point guard? Did she ask you what you wanted to run?
Yes.
How often?
You know, Coach Summitt has a great relationship with her perimeter players, and having been fortunate enough to play a point guard in her system, there was communication throughout the game all the time and just instilling confidence in you as a player. And you look at this team and what she's done with Shannon Bobbitt, a junior college player who's in her first year in the program, and how big she played that tonight. I think a lot of that is the confidence that Coach Summitt instilled in Shannon.
Well, she is small, but she certainly did play big. Do not forget, when we're down here, SportsCenter is up next. Barry Bonds with a surprise in the Giants opener. What's the latest on Pac-Man Jones? That's all coming up on SportsCenter, but it is now time to give the victors their spoils, as in the trophy. Mark Jones, down low.
All right, thanks a lot, Trey. Your 2007 NCAA Women's Champions, Tennessee Volunteers, want to introduce Dr. Miles Brand, the president of the NCAA, and Julie Souther, the chair of the NCAA Women's Basketball Committee.
First of all, to everyone in the audience, thank you, Cleveland, for a great and memorable tournament. And now, on behalf of the NCAA and the Division I Women's Basketball Committee, it's our pleasure to present the National Championship Trophy to our 2007 champions, Coach Pat Summitt and Tennessee.
Coach, this is number 7 for you. It was a long time between this one and the last one. What makes this group here so unique?
Mark, this team started working in the offseason, and my message to them is that national championships are won in the offseason, and they really committed. I mean, they stayed in summer school, and they worked out, and they challenged each other, and Heather Mason worked them hard in our weight training, and they just they came together. You know, I think to win anything, you have to be a tight team. They believed in each other, and obviously they all had one goal, and that was to be here in Cleveland and cut down the nets, and I'm really, really proud of this team.
You talked about wanting to use your scissors to cut the nets down. You got many contributions tonight from different people, Bobbitt, Anisicki on the glass, Candace Parker, and other intangible efforts. But when you look at your turning point in the season, where did it all turn for the better?
I think when we lost to LSU in the SEC tournament, I think it's the best thing that happened to us. It was painful. Never like to lose, but we really came together as a team and redefined our goals and our individual commitment to the team goal. And I would say that they've held each other accountable. I don't even have to worry about them. They call each other out. Occasionally I call them out. But tonight, I want you to know how proud I am of this team and how they deserve this because of the commitment that they made.
All right, thanks a lot, Coach. Congratulations. I want to get Candace Parker in here. Candace? Candace, tonight came out and set the tone early with especially your passing. What does it mean to be now a national champion?
I can't even describe it. This is something I've dreamed of ever since I was a little kid. This is what all of us came to Tennessee to do, and we did it.
I think what a lot of people want to know right now is your future plans. There's been a little speculation out there about whether you'll come back or not. Is this the time to maybe start the one more year chant?
Come on now. Why wouldn't I come back and wear orange another year? Why wouldn't I? Why wouldn't I? Why wouldn't I?
When you look at some of the special players and some of the special memories you'll take away from the season, what are they?
It's just not just on the court, but off the court. We were a really close team. We had each other's back, and I love them. I really love it. I love my teammates.
Congratulations. Trey, back to you.
All right. Mark, thanks very much. A lot of love for Tennessee right now, and they certainly love to rebound in this contest. Absolutely beasts on the board. 24 offensive rebounds in this contest for Tennessee, 42 overall. That's really where they won this game. It is joy in Knoxville and tears in Piscataway. But hey, don't forget, no seniors on that Rutgers squad. They will be back. And you just heard Candace Parker say she will be back for another year. We're coming right back to put this tournament to rest. Stay with us.
Flight 27 has been canceled due to weather. Our next departure is 6 a.m. tomorrow.
No, hey, lady.
It's time to play Take On Orbits. Today's players have bad weather, must book a hotel before the other 200 passengers. Go.
Oakwood?
Yes.
Dentmore.
Oh, no vacancy. Orbits TLC lets you find a hotel right from your phone. Next time, Orbits and go.
Honey, look at this.
Is it for all of us?
Yeah.
Magic begins when you realize you can afford a Disney vacation. Other affordable packages all year long. Visit DisneyWorld.com/affordable.
Marshall's Law number 265. Always think of the driveway as a runway. Get fashions from the designers you saw on the catwalk for the price of a copycat. Those who know Marshall's Law.
No, I was actually a bit of an early starter. Well, I've probably invested quite a bit of money by now. You know, a little here, a little there. I should be in pretty good shape when I finally decide to call it a day. Well, fingers crossed.
they pick up their games, pick up their teams, and pick up the pace. Enterprise salutes NCAA student athletes for picking us all up. Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Happiness between Nikki Anasicki and Pat Summitt. Shannon Bobbitt finally got some height. Kate McMahon got ups as well. Tennessee, it is their time in the spotlight. The final score here in Cleveland, 59-46. SportsCenter is next. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For Stacey Dales, Carol Lawson, and our entire ESPN crew, it has been our pleasure to be with you for the 2007 NCAA Final Four, where for the seventh time, Tennessee are the champions. Good night from Cleveland. It is time now for Tennessee to fly into the night and enjoy the title.
Center.
We head back out to Cleveland with more on Tennessee's seventh national championship. Also, the Giants unveiling Barry Zito on opening day today in San Francisco. The other Barry, though, stealing the show. And after his meeting with the NFL commish, hear why Pac-Man Jones could be banned for the entire 2007 season. The favorite to win this year's Masters? Not who you might think. His name and numbers on SportsCenter now.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to SportsCenter. Fred Hickman alongside John Buchagross on the night that the new champion of women's college basketball has been crowned.
To the summit again for the Volunteers. Tennessee earns its seventh national championship. Hall of Fame coach Pat Summitt has been the coach for all of them. We go back out to Cleveland and Trey Wingo for highlights and reaction to the national championship game for the ladies. Trey. Cleveland, hello. It is time. time to party in Knoxville. Rocky Top on top again. Welcome into SportsCenter's coverage of the Women's NCAA Championship game. Trey Wingo alongside Kara Lawson and Stacey Dales. 20 years after Pat Summitt wins her first national title, right here at the Quicken Loans Arena, she wraps up her seventh. It was a struggle from the start, but Tennessee was able to pull away. Two good friends in C. Vivian Stringer and Rutgers, and Pat Summitt and Tennessee squaring off to see who would walk away with the national championship. These two have been friends since they traveled together in the 70s. Summitt going for seven, Vivian looking for her first. First half, Candace Parker, tough turnaround, gave Tennessee a four-point lead, but Rutgers kept it close in the first half, Kara.
Yeah, they did it with their defense in the first half. You see the freshman there with a nice pass off penetration. They were able to get in the paint in the first 20 minutes, Trey.
That put Rutgers only down two, but then they got the ball down low to Candace, and near the baseline, she's almost impossible. Parker, 7 points in the first half. Later in the first, Nikki Anasicki was a beast, Stacey.
Yeah, she was. The only word that comes to mind is relentless. 10 offensive rebounds. She was the difference in this game, Trey.
27-7-18 at that point. Ending seconds of the first half, same score. Parker showing the vision here, Kara.
Yeah, she figured out those double teams. She used her 6'5 height to find her open teammates. Anasicki with a nice finish.
Tennessee up by 11 at the break. And in the second half, the Lady Vols keeping the pressure on. Parker, offensive board, gets swarmed, but finds Shannon Bobbitt, who drains a three. She had huge threes in the second half. Lady Vols up 10, and then more Bobbitt. She's small, but she played huge. 41-28, same score. Tennessee now playing good defense here, Kara.
Yeah, Shannon Bobbitt and Nikki Anasicki have been the energy. They've been the players that have really jump-started this team throughout the tournament.
An easy bucket there for Alexis Hornbuckle. And then one more time, they broke the press, Dace.
Yeah, one more time, you leave Shannon Bobbitt open, and that's a 4 3-pointers for in this game. When you stretch the floor like that, the inside opens up. Tennessee dominated the paint.
I think Vivian's look said it all. What else can we do? Better defense by Tennessee than Rutgers tonight, and a great steal and a finish by Hornbuckle. That put him up by 15, and the confetti came down. Candace Parker said she came to Tennessee to win a championship so she could be included with the greats. She hands that lady, Pat Summitt, the seventh of her career. The final score from Cleveland, 59-46. Give Rutgers credit. They never gave up. Kia Vaughn a double-double, 20-10. Candace Parker, 17-7, named the most outstanding player. But Pat Summitt no longer has to answer the question, how come you haven't won one since 1998?
They had to do that on their own. It was amazing when I saw them in the fall, the level of commitment they made in the weight room and on the court and working on their skills. And they're a much better team, and I feel like they deserve this.
How much does this championship mean in terms of validating your collegiate career?
I don't even care about that. I just wanted to win a national championship, and this team did that. Our banner is going to be in the rafters for forever, and we left our mark on Tennessee.
Just to put into perspective what it means for Pat Summitt to win her seventh, only John Wooden's 10 stand between her and being the most prodigious title winner, man or woman, in Division I NCAA history. Kara Lawson, you know Pat better than Stacey and I. You were a part of this program. What do you think this win means for her?
Well, I think this win means a lot, and Pat is a very humble person. She's not somebody that's going to tout all of her accomplishments, but I tell you what, I know what's out in the distance, and I know in her mind, she looks at that 10 titles by John Wooden, which pretty much everyone thinks is an untouchable record. And with her seventh tonight, with Candace Parker returning for another year, you just kind of get the feeling, Stacey, that Pat Summitt is going to make a big old run after those 10 titles of John Wooden.
Well, Kara, you used the word humble. It's just amazing to me the humility that Pat Summitt has. And I was sitting with her yesterday and talking with the legend, asking her how is she different coming into this tournament as the head coach at Tennessee after 33 years? And she said, well, Stacey, I don't have all the answers. I actually defer to my players. I ask them what they want to run, defensively, offensively. It's amazing to see such a classy person represent the game so well.
Just so you know, this is supposed to be a neutral site, but it sure had the look and feel of a home game tonight for Tennessee. You mentioned Candace Parker said in the postgame interview she is coming back for another year, or to accurately quote her, why wouldn't I come back for another year? What did she do tonight, in your mind, to her legacy, no matter what she does next?
Yeah, this was, to me, this game was Candace Parker's defining moment. She's the best player in the country. She's been talked about since she stepped foot on campus in Knoxville as being one of the great players. And tonight, she cements that legacy by leading her team to a national championship. She's up with all the grace right now with getting that title. She didn't have stellar games offensively in the Final Four, but when you look at the attention paid to her on the block, double and triple teams, she had the ability and she got it done, and getting the other players involved and helping them score easier.
The sign of true greatness. If they're putting four people on me, somebody else is open. Candace Parker had an exceptional tournament, most outstanding player. But boy, if you're giving a hustle award, Stacey, it's got to be to the rebounding machine of Nikki Anasicki.
She was absolutely phenomenal throughout the entire NCAA tournament in the women's game. I think in this tournament, she really defined herself as the MVP on that hustle side, because she had 16 rebounds in this basketball game, 17 at the offensive end. The only word that comes to mind is relentless. Leadership also comes to mind with this player. She was bound and determined to win a championship for her team. It was the supplementary players that got it done. Candace Parker's phenomenal, but the role players did it tonight.
And she also did it in the semifinal against North Carolina when they really didn't have the energy. As for Rutgers, you wanted to see if they could shoot the same way they did in that semifinal against LSU. They just couldn't get that done. Vivian Stringer now speaking about the loss for Rutgers.
But I don't want to put such a damper on it that it defines us and we're nothing. I think that there's so much credit that has to be given to the young ladies who came from nothing to do so much and basically stun everybody and everybody in the world to the point where people could actually believe that we might be able to do some things. And I think that probably for the most part, when we saw the light at the end of the tunnel, we actually believed that too. But for some reason, maybe we read the headlines, maybe we realized it was a national championship game. We looked like we were, you know, struck like a deer struck in the headlights, simple as that. And by the time we, you know, rocked from that, just decided just to settle down, it was a bit much. And that's, I'm sorry about that for the players and for us and so many other people that, you know, would have liked to share that. But I still love my team, and I think they did a wonderful job. And I'm really proud because they gave me a lot of confidence in, you know, young people who struggle. I think that as a coach, what you want to see is you want to see the opportunity to mold young people's minds and their character and all those other things. And this was no doubt the most rewarding year that I've had. And so I guess I'm good for a while. I feel good about that.
Let's take a couple.
Well, give Vivian Stringer and Rutgers a lot of credit. They never gave up, and they're not going away. This is a team that came within one game of winning it all without a senior essentially on their roster.
Yeah, you look at the makeup of this team, and they just have just great toughness, tremendous work ethic, and this is a team that's you're gonna have to be a force to be reckoned with in the next couple years. And I love the players on this team, Stacey. We had an opportunity to visit with them. They're so inspiring, and I think they're inspired by their coach, and you can't wait to see how they continue to develop as young players.
Yeah, there's no question, Kara, they're inspired by their coach. Vivian Stringer, in a nutshell, is a tireless worker. She doesn't sleep at night. She lives on coffee, and she gets her players to buy into her identity, and her identity is defending you and defending you better than anybody else in America. These players will be back next year. Epiphany Prince impressed me as a freshman for Vivian Stringer, and Essence Carson to me is an underrated player that's going to be sensational in the year to come.
And then you have Mati Ajavan and Kia Vaughn as well, and this has to be a weird feeling for Pat at some level, because she and Vivian are very close friends. They go back years. They actually roomed together at USA basketball festivals in the 70s trying to recruit players to take for the national team. Lots more coming from Cleveland later on SportsCenter, including a visit with Pat Summitt and the most outstanding player of the tournament, Candace Parker. That's it for now. Let's send it back to Bristol.
Thank you, Trey. More from the Women's Final Four inside SportsCenter. But first, the new guy in San Francisco taking on San Diego's ace. Who got rocked, and did Barry Bonds do any of the rocking? Also ahead, Tiger currently warming up at Augusta, but why Phil Mickelson is perhaps the bigger favorite to win this year's Masters. Plus, don't miss why Pac-Man Jones isn't the only player possibly facing significant suspensions in 07. Details coming up.
Philly cheesesteak or Brooklyn style? Which Domino's pizza is best? You could ask a wise man. We ask the Wisemans from Short Lawn, New Jersey.
Philly cheesesteak, yeah. Steak and cheese, cheese and steak. Tastes great with a hot cup of coffee.
Come on, Brooklyn style, that's pizza. But you gotta fold it. Such a big slice you could eat for a week.
Loaded with steak and cheese, Philly cheesesteak is back and ready to rumble with Brooklyn style. Big slice, big toppings, gotta fold it. Get a medium Philly cheesesteak or a large one-topping Brooklyn style pizza for $9.99.
It went through your mind when you realized you guys were going to win?
Just, I think at first it was just excitement, realizing that I hate y'all. Realizing that we won, obviously, you know, relief, obviously, because we've done so hard, we've worked so hard to get to the point where we're at right now, and we're just really excited that we're national champs.
We have time for, we'll take two more right here. And then we'll end with you.
Alexis, in the middle. Can you talk about just the commitment to offensive rebounding you guys made tonight, and could you sense a frustration on Rutgers' part because of that?
Well, I think Nikki said it best when Coach just emphasized that rebounding wins championships, and we have to allow ourselves to get second and third chances. You know, we hadn't shot the ball last night too well, and we didn't really expect things to change. And if you go in like that, you're going to get the offensive rebound. Rebounding is not, you know, all about the height or who can jump the highest. It's about the heart and hustle and who wants the ball the most, and that's how we approached it.
Take our last question right here, front left.
Shannon, right here. Coach Stringer was a little bit frustrated that Epiphany Prince didn't close down on you after you'd made 1 3 and then 2 3s. She said the girl was shooting from 4-point range. You got to get out of there on her. Were you surprised that you wound up with that much room after you started getting hot?
Excuse me, what did he say?
That you had that much room to get your threes off.
I just definitely took what the defense gave me. I felt like I had enough room to release the ball. I stand 5'2", so I definitely got to create space. And I felt like I had enough space to shoot the ball, and that's what I did.
Great. Thank you, all five of you. There's approximately 10 minutes left on Tennessee's open locker room, and we will now begin Q&A with head coach Pat Summitt. Start right behind.
It's going to be a long night.
Coach.
Yes.
Rutgers prides itself on their man-to-man. Were you a little bit surprised that they kind of fluctuated back and forth in the first half, and the second half primarily?
Defensive execution versus man has been pretty sharp, and I really anticipated that we would see zone. We spent some significant minutes on just working and rehearsing all of our zone action, and because I told our team even before the game, it won't surprise me at all if we see a lot of zone. I think we'll see man in the initial stages, because with Candace Parker and the offensive schemes that we have for her, she's much more difficult to defend if we're going against man, because we can play her at all five positions and get some good screening action. In the zone, it's a little more difficult because they really packed it in. The good part of that is that's when Shannon hit her threes. I thought that was a key time in the game to really take some pressure off of us, and in our defense stayed where it needed to stay. But I wasn't surprised we saw a significant amount of zone.
Right here, front left.
Coach Summitt right here. Do you think it's possible that next year we could see Candace elevate her game to an even higher level, simply because she'll have this whole pressure of winning a national championship off her back? She'll have that relief and be able to just play more freely even?
Well, I think Candace is very serious about her game, so I think she will get better. I don't know that the pressure really affected Candace in a negative way. You know, I think she got a little frustrated today, but I think that had more to do with Rutgers' defense. You know, we had some possessions where we really couldn't get her on the block.
They did a nice job of, you know, playing from behind and forcing her out somewhat. And she's accustomed to, and that came more in the zone than the man. And I think that probably caused her to face up more and fade a little bit in her shooting. But Candace will be better next year because Candace is very serious about her game, and she's constantly working on it. And that's why this team sat here tonight with a national championship is because of their dedication in the off season. And I just preached that over and over and over last spring, before they went into their summer school. That if you want to win a national championship, you're going to do it in the off season.
Straight back.
That said about Candace obviously not having a great offensive night, what does it speak to her maturity that she found open people, she rebounded, she did everything else despite her frustration?
Well, I think that's a big part of Candace's maturity as a player. A year ago, she might have been more frustrated by not being able to be as efficient on the court and having double team action on her. Her composure this year has been significant to the success of our half-court offense when teams elect to double-team her. I think she, it's like pick your poison. If you're going to double her, she will find players and get the ball into the open hands. And it's very unselfish in that regard. And, I think that that's been a big part of her maturity and not getting frustrated. There were games early on that Candace got very frustrated because she would not only get double teamed, she would get triple teamed, and people would really bring physical play against her. And she just matured as we've gone along. And our schedule has had a lot to do with our success in postseason. I mean, we played North Carolina, and having played North Carolina, I think that helped us on this stage. And obviously, having played against LSU, and a North Carolina, I thought about going into this game against Rutgers, who they reminded me of from just a defensive standpoint and their ability, obviously, to run the floor and make plays. And those two teams came to my mind. I think Candace Parker is the best player in the country, and she makes everyone else better. And having Candace Parker, yes, you got a Candace Parker, you got a chance to win a national championship. But it's not because she's the only player on our team. It's because she makes everyone else better. And this team takes a lot of pride individually in being a part of the plan of attack and the success. Nikki Anasicki has great pride in her game. Alexis, Alexis didn't shoot the ball well in our last three games in postseason, but just her leadership. We needed her leadership. Shannon got open looks because they paid more attention to what was going on the inside than the outside.
Right here in the front.
Coach, two things. One, Alberta Augustus in the first half, and two, while you talk about all your sets and all the things you played, a couple one-on-one plays, one by Alexis, and then one by Sydney Spencer really there late, went baseline and just kind of pulled up. Can you kind of address those? Because those kind of separated you as well.
Well, first of all, Alberta Augusti had a great game. She's had a great tournament for us. And I've probably been harder on her than anyone else on this team other than Dominique Redding. It's been Dominique and Alberta. As coaches, I guess sometimes you've just got the ones that you think you have to stay on. But the reason I stayed on the two of them is I knew that one of those two players had to be ready to contribute and contribute in a very positive way for us in postseason. And Alberta was the one that had the biggest impact. And I think she played with a lot of confidence. And I kept telling her, I'm on you for a reason because I really think that you can make a difference. And if Alexis is in foul trouble or if we want to go with our quickest lineup, you're going to be on the floor. So obviously she did a great job. Second part? Oh, those shots. I think that both those players understood that they had to step up and contribute. Obviously they hadn't shot the ball particularly well. But I thought we got really aggressive when we had to be aggressive offensively, and those were big plays for us.
Time for just a couple more. We'll take one in the back here.
Pat, from a personal standpoint, is this one a little sweeter or more special for you because of the time that had passed since the last one?
Actually, no. And I'm just being honest with you. This is not about winning number seven. This is about this team winning their first. And, you know, I think it's different for me now. And all I can tell you, it was like another game. And when I came here today, it wasn't like we're playing for a national championship. It's like, you know, we went through our same routine. But my thought was, and I told them, we sat in the center court in Stokely in our hot gym that we practice in because we were not in our main arena. And I told them, I said, you know, I want this so much for you all, and our staff is going to work hard for you. I mean, my assistants have just been incredible in their preparation, their motivation, and just how they've helped manage the game as it went along. But for me tonight, it was all about helping this team. And that's why in our game against North Carolina, I said, we're not leaving here without a national championship, because I really believed this team deserved to be national champs. And so it's, you know, it's obviously great for the university and state of Tennessee and our fans, and I'm proud, very proud.
Well, apparently she did Rocky Top proud when she dressed up as a cheerleader. Tennessee now with 7 national championships.
They are the sharpshooters.
Tennessee got a very tough schedule. Maryland was a 2-seed, defending national champion. Oklahoma with Courtney Parrish, the 3-seed. And the 4-seed, Ohio State, the Big Ten regular season champions.
But you know what? Of all of her 7 championships, this was her easiest to win. First round, Drake, easy. Pitt, that was kind of a tough one in the second round. But remember Marist, the great run for the Red Foxes. Marist in the Sweet 16, that was an easy game. Then remember Ole Miss beat Oklahoma. Ole Miss, a 7-seed, that's who they played to get to the Final Four, blew them out. And then here they are. They have to play North Carolina. That was tough. I give them credit there. Good win. But then you have to play Rutgers. Rutgers would have been the highest seed in terms of a 4-seed to win a national championship. An easy win in a championship. An easy title for Tennessee.
Okay, well, they get their 7th title. The big question you talked about, see Vivian Stringer maybe going to LSU. A lot of speculation. Does Candace Parker leave? I think she answered it in that press conference.
She said, I'm coming back. I'm coming back. Well, that's great news for Tennessee. With her coming back, I think they're going to be one of the best teams in college basketball. I don't think they're going to be best, though. I didn't pick them to win the national title this year. I didn't expect Duke to go out or Maryland to go out the way they did. Not even Oklahoma, which was my pick. I think next year, UConn wins the national championship. Maya Moore with the talent back. Renee Montgomery, Tina Charles. Remember, this is a team with Sharday Houston. Everybody's back. I think UConn is the best team in America next year.
Okay, well, that's next year. How about this year? Top 3 stories before we finish the season of this season.
I don't think any question. The biggest story is Kay Yao. What a story it was at NC State. This is a woman dealing with stage 4 breast cancer. It reoccurred. She did away with it for a while, and then it came back, and she's been dealing with it all season long. And what are you? This is a Hall of Famer, an Olympic gold medalist, and she did everything she could. Won 25 games, lost 10, made it to the season for her. How about Duke, winning 30 in a row, only team ever to go undefeated through ACC regular season play. But then they lose to Rutgers on free throws by Lindsey Harding. And Gale Guest, of course, now off to Texas. No one knows what to expect for the Duke Blue Devils. My final thought is parity. I talked about Marist making it to the Sweet 16. I felt like before in women's basketball, it was a talent puddle that the big programs always took the best talent out of. Tennessee, UConn, LSU, Texas. Now it really is a talent pool. We saw Bowling Green advance to the Sweet 16. Ole Miss, Marist. This is great for women's college basketball. It's the only thing that's going to get closer to men's hoops, those great Cinderella stories, which is what they need in women's hoops.
Well, Greg, thank you so much for all of your insight and for a great year covering women's college basketball. That'll do it from here at the Fieldhouse in New York. A phenomenal...
Bobcats. Miami win.
Congratulations. 7th championship is yours. Wait.